Rosh Him, Yom Shai, Rosh Him, Kahadash.
Hey, Shalom, hey, double honors to our apostles and our elders, the great Muslim, who we all learned under. Alright, we're out here another Saturday teaching at the camp. Over here in Batura, hey man, Lord's will, what we get into, Lord's will, your brothers are edified. Alright?
First Timothy chapter 4, verse 10, and it says, "For therefore we both labor and suffer reproach, because we trust in the living Yahweh, Bahashim Yahushai, who is the Savior of all men, specifically of those that believe."
And so whatever we go through in this truth, man, it's all, hey, like it says in Romans, the 12th chapter, it's all for our reasonable service, man. This is our duty to do. It doesn't matter who slanders us, who talks, you know, all type of madness about us. We're going to teach in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. All right? Continue on.
It says, "Who is the Savior of all men, specifically of those that believe?"
Specifically, he came for a remnant. All right, the elect, the 144,000 and the one-third of Israel that are out here, man. All right, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. Those of you on the side.
"These things command and teach. Let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example." "These things command and teach."
That's what we were called out here to do, man, to come out here and teach. First, you learn, you get yourself rooted in these scriptures, and then you go out there and teach. Like Yahweh Shai told Peter, man, he asked him three times whether he had love towards him. Man. You know, and then he replied three times, man, to feed his flock. You know?
Verse 12, "Let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity."
Yeah, for the most part, you know, when the Lord called us, man, he called us, you know, in our youth, when we were young, you know, young men in this thing. But the thing about it is, man, you know, we're still supposed to set examples for the men that are out here, man, you know, that come into this truth, man. All right, you know, how one conducts himself, how one, you know, that serves Yahweh Bashem Yahushai is to conduct, you know, himself.
It says, "Till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine."
And starting from our apostles and elders, man, that's all that they push, man. All right, you know, they're always pushing the videos, man. They're always pushing you, you know, to level up, to be sharper in this thing, man. All right? You know, that lines up with what the scripture's saying, man. Give attendance to reading. All right, can you read that?
I got a scripture, right? Yeah. Revelation 1 and 3. "Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand."
Yeah. It all starts with reading.
Yeah.
And it's a never-ending thing. This world is likened unto living waters. Mm-hmm. You know, you have people in this world that think that they can just read the book, read the scriptures, think, "Oh, I said, I'll put it back in my library or something." No, this is not no ordinary book, man. It's not a book where you can just read and say you read the whole thing. No, this book takes time and diligence to actually understand the spirit. Yahweh Bashem Yahushai has to be working with you,
yeah,
to be able to understand what is written in this book. Because it's a mystery. As it is written, the mysteries are given to what? The prophets. The servants of the prophets.
That's the spirit, man. Every time you enter, you reread in some of these books, man, you're always learning something new, like the brother's saying, man.
Right.
Through the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, that's revealed unto you.
Hey, because you're doing what? You're looking at words you don't understand.
Yeah.
Looking into blue letters, going to the Hebrew, going to the Greek. Alright, you go to the etymology of a word, you go to precepts.
Yep.
What does scripture say? King David said, "Through thy precepts I get understanding."
That's right.
Okay, precept upon precept, line upon line. Alright? Because that helps you understand what the scriptures are saying. Go to the precepts, man.
And it also is like an onion, man. It has layers. You know, different scriptures have different meanings and double meanings as well. You know, you read it one time and it means one thing. You read it again and it means something totally different.
Let's So Ezekiel 3:1. Moreover, he said unto me, Son of man, eat thou findest, eat this roll and go speak unto the house of Israel. So I opened my mouth and he caused me to eat that roll. And he said unto me, Son of man, cause thy belly to eat and fill thy bowels with this roll that I give thee. Then did I eat it, and it was in my mouth as honey for sweetness. Now, eating this roll is digesting this word, man. You know, gaining the understanding of this word, digesting it, you know, and teaching it, man. That's the whole point of this thing, man. All right, so like you said, it goes back to that reading. You know, you gotta acquaint yourself with the scriptures, man. For real, man.
And actually be a doer of the word, not just
that's
a hearer.
Right, that's right.
Apply to what you're learning.
There's
a lot of, like, you have people that say Bible stands for the acronyms.
Basic instructions before leaving Earth.
Right. And they do give you instructions, you know?
It's a manual book.
Right.
God, but the most important thing, coming to this truth, you have to be taught. You know, by the apostles and elders. You know, teachers from the Most High said.
So right.
You can't self-teach a thing in this truth, man. I got proof, sir. This is Jeremiah 3:15. Now give you pastors according to mine heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding.
Right, what does a pastor do? A pastor is dealing with the sheep. They're hands-on with the sheep. Guarding the sheep, protecting the sheep, guiding the sheep,
feeding the sheep.
Most importantly,
yeah.
Right? Yahweh Shai said, what? If you love me, feed my sheep.
Yeah.
So if the Lord is setting you up, you're to guide men. You're to teach men. Okay? And that's why you gotta get this truth for yourself. You can't be out here on some mockingbird, S-H-I-T, man.
No, that's why the scriptures say, blessed is he who readeth, man.
Exactly.
Because the one who readeth, man, he's not being a mockingbird. You know,
right.
He's diligently, you know, seeking out the understanding.
Right, and the Lord's gonna suffer you.
Yeah.
The Lord, the scriptures say, Paul watered, Apollos watered, but the Heavenly Father giveth the increase, man. So once the Lord see that you want it, once you're seeking the Lord diligently, the Lord, he's gonna level you up in the spirit, man. You know? I think that brother, you wanna read that again?
And I'll give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding.
Right, this is according to the Lord's heart, man. We ain't out here just saying things, man. Like the wingmasters, right? Just saying, you know, whatever. Nah, man, we ain't doing that, man. We going according to the doctrine. The doctrine gotta be on point.
This is 2 Timothy 4:1.
You gotta raise your voice up, huh?
Me?
Yeah.
Really?
The mic is over there.
Okay. It's 2 Timothy 4:1.
Pick you up.
It says, I charge thee therefore before the Most High and the Lord, Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom, preach the word.
Ooh.
Be instant in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine.
And that's the spirit, man. Hey, when Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, when he returns, there's going to be no excuse, man. All right, he's coming to judge everyone, man, out of all Israel, man. He's saying right now, that again,
brother. It says, preach the word.
You want to start it?
Yeah, preach the word. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Mm. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine.
That's a year-round thing.
So, like the scriptures say, man, we're supposed to work out our own salvation, you know, with fear and trembling.
So
it's about being diligent in this thing, man. All right.
Wrong. No matter what the weather is, you know, whether the sun is bright, whether it's raining, whether it's cold as hell, you gotta show your faith to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai coming out here and dealing with the elements.
Right, there's a proverb on that, right?
The slugger will not plow in the reason of the cold.
Reason of the cold, man. Mm-hmm. You know, the Lord, hey, when we out here and it's freezing, guess what? People are out here too, walking about.
Right.
You know, when the apostles used to be on 34th and whatever street, I think it was 7th or something like that.
Yeah, 34th to 7th.
In New York. It's freezing out there. People are still out there, tourists and all of that, man. So you saying we can't be out there? You know, when it's hella hot outside, people still out and about doing what they do.
Hey, your harness has true soldiers. Hey, we are chosen to be Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
And as a soldier, you gotta be able to endure all the elements. Hot, cold, whatever, your station.
gotta be able to be uncomfortable, man.
Yeah. It doesn't matter how you're feeling, whether you're motivated or not, man. It's all about, and there's work to be done.
That's what?
Yeah.
Discipline.
That's discipline, man. Because when Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai returns, man, like we said earlier, there's not gonna be an excuse, man. It's whether did you do everything you can to serve the Lord or not. Alright?
You gotta jump to Saturday, man. You gotta.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We hoping Saturdays come quicker than, you know?
This is happening right now. We seeing this part right here playing out as I'm speaking. It says, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears.
That's the false prophets. Exactly. Your wingmasters and such. Just making shit up.
Yeah.
As if it's not important on what you teach. It's very important, man, because once again, like the brother read, the pastors, you're leading sheep. You can lead, you can, like what the Lord said, blind leaders are blind, and both are falling to the ditch. You want that blood on your hands?
Right.
Fuck that. I mean, select it. F that.
Forget that.
Yeah, forget that.
It says, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned into fables.
Lies, dude.
That's on point right there, right now.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what's going on in Israel right now, man.
Yep.
Okay, and a lot of people are going to be led astray by that, you know. But if the Lord is dealing with you, He's going to not let you fall into that trap, man.
Right. Yeah. A lot of these false pastors out here, these false apostles, you know, they're pushing this thing for that filthy lucre thing. You know, that money,
gain,
fortune, whatever, you know? Hey. So they're not really teaching the true doctrine. Hey, because somebody told them not to do it, they gave them that first to do it, they don't want to do it.
Right.
Because they don't truly believe, you know? But when that famine of the word hits, man, hey, the people that they led astray, they're going to become looking for the real truth, man. They're not going to be able to find it. All that blood is going to be on your hands, you know?
Yeah. They don't consider that they're doing evil.
Yeah.
Okay? The evil that they're doing right now is for later. Okay, it's going to manifest itself later. When that MOTB come out,
yep.
You know what I'm saying? And they take heed to their counsel instead of the counsel of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, okay, it's going to be hell to tell the captain, as they say.
And they're making mockery of the real men of the Lord.
Oh, man.
They are talking about some great mess. Man. Hey, man, you gotta be careful. Tread lightly, man. You know, the scripture says, fear the Lord and reverence His priest. You know, we're talking about men that been laboring since the 80s, early 90s, man.
Exactly.
You know the Lord with them. Yeah. Never took no breaks. You know?
A lot of men become novice, looking for pride.
Oh, yeah.
They think they become greater than the men that taught them. The word said.
They're like those little children that came out of militia. Because in the faith, they're like 7, 8 years old.
If that.
And they're coming up against almost 40-year-old men.
But they ain't going the right way.
Right.
At 7, 8 years, they ain't really 7, 8 years. You ain't going in the right way.
Right, but they just coming up mocking, you know. And the Lord, what did you send? She bears on them? Okay? So you guys better be careful, man. Because you're going against the men of the Lord. The men that Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai set up. And the scripture said, if this thing would come to naught, if it was not of the Lord, it would come to naught, man. Okay, and they've been going strong. Okay,
everyone that goes up against them,
falls.
Eventually, fall by the wayside, man.
I get 50 minutes of fame and then I've forgotten about it.
Because really, I'm sorry, brother. Go ahead.
No, I'm staying going.
Yeah, really, you're going up against Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, man.
That's right.
That's really what you're doing. You know.
Hey, you know, they have to play their role too, man. They're just
fulfilling
prophecy. The scripture says in the last days, it's going to come scoffers, man.
That's right.
Yeah. So you're going to have these men that are going to mock the true men of the world, the true apostles, you know, all the way down. You know, but hey, just know that's just your sure sign that you're doing the right thing. You know?
Right.
People go up against you.
Yeah, like Mayweather. What the fuck he say against Mayweather? In the ring. I mean, so like I said, what the WTF, right? Now, I'm cussing a lot.
Yeah.
Now, that dude was bad. But every time he walked to the wind, the whole crowd boomed. Every time, bro.
Because, hey, we're going to have haters.
Yeah.
Because people hate the truth.
Yeah.
He's the truth in the ring.
Yeah.
He's really, you see him getting in the ring with the YouTuber?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. And he was just having fun with him.
No, it was a young 18-year-old.
Okay.
Mayweather was just trolling.
Man, them skills ain't going away, man.
Yeah.
Even if he stopped for like a year, them shit ain't going away, man. He dedicated his whole life to it.
So they hated Yahweh Shai, man. They persecuted Yahweh Shai. Ultimately, they killed Yahweh Shai.
Yeah.
Because they making a decision, preaching the truth, man.
Sticking to it, and then following through, and then just saying.
They hate them that rebuke it at the game, man. You know, just like it says in John 3, man, they hated the light, man. Because it showed that their deeds were evil, man. And that's why, you know, whenever we get to the truth, man, there's always going to be those haters, those scoffers, man.
It's jealousy, too.
Yeah.
They want to be the top guys.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You don't know the hell that comes with being the top guy.
Yeah.
Nor are the top guys like, man, I want to be the top guy. Let me be the... They're not... It wasn't like that in their mind, man. They just held on to the faith.
Right. And the Lord put hell on the top guys, too.
Yeah.
You know?
That's what Paul spoke about. You know, basically the troubles that come with, you know, dealing with all the churches, man.
Right, exactly.
So that's a responsibility.
I
had something slug here, bro. Go ahead.
No, you got it.
Go ahead.
Sirach 7 and
that's
4.
It, that's it.
Seek not of the Lord preeminence.
Right, preeminence, going back to being first. You know, guys want to be that top dude. What they say? It's an acronym, head nigga in charge.
Yeah. That's it.
You know, dudes want to be the top dudes. The scripture say, he that think if he's somebody, he that think if he's something, deceiveth himself, man. You know?
Seek not of the Lord preeminence, neither of the king the seat of honor. Hey, like, have you seen the movie The King on Netflix?
The King, I don't know.
The movie.
The Boy Henry?
Yeah, I think so.
Something like that.
Yeah. He didn't know he was gonna be king.
He didn't even want to be king.
Nah.
Bro.
But they put him to be king.
Yeah.
You know?
Just like the man in the Iron Mask. There's so many movies that have that theme.
Right.
And that's how it is with the top guys. They don't strive to be the top dude. Yeah. It's just they're naturally built for that position.
Like King David.
Exactly, yeah. Like King David.
Perfect example.
Perfect example, bro.
And the Lord said what? He said, I rule in the king of all men, right? The Lord sets up the king, okay? The rulership on the earth belongs to the Lord. He sets you up to be the ruler. He sets you up to be the king. He sets up everything, man.
And the greatest example is Korah. He was the greatest example of trying to exalt himself.
Oh, yeah. He tried to be above Moses.
Yeah.
Mary.
That's how the spirit of these guys win.
But it's windy, y'all, bro. Should, you know, leave them in there.
They're trying to have that seat where the Most High is dealing with them. But the Lord ain't dealing with them like that.
Yeah, we got to get that Acts 5. But I got some.
This is
going
to come with them. Luke chapter 14 and 7. And he put forth a parable to those which were bidden. And when he marked how they chose out the chief rooms, saying unto them, when thou art bidden of any man to a wedding, sit not down in the highest room, lest a more honorable man than thou be bidden of him.
So this is a parable that Yahweh Shai, you know, he's telling everybody pretty much, man, it's more important to be humble in this thing, man. Don't go out there trying to exalt your own self, man. All right, when you're going into a supper or a dinner or a party, don't be the first one, you know, to be the head of the table, man. All right, to think that.
It's pretty much a parable about not exalting yourself, you know.
Other way.
I'm sorry, brother.
Verse 8, and when thou art bidden of any man to a wedding, sit not down in the highest room, lest a more honorable man than thou be bidden of him.
So you're going to make yourself look like an ass pretty much, man. If you're out there, you know, trying to make it seem like you're the most honorable man sitting at the head, man. And when you're told, hey, move aside, you know, this other man has come, you know, you're going to look foolish, pretty much.
You're going to save yourself the embarrassment. You're just taking the low route every time.
And that's what it's going to say.
And he that bade thee and him come and say to thee, give this man place, and thou begin with shame to take the lowest food.
Yeah.
And it says, verse 10, but when thou art bidden, go and sit down in the lowest room, that when he that bade thee cometh, he may say unto thee, friend, go up higher. Then thou shalt have worship in the presence of them that sit at meat with thee.
Yeah, so don't be out there trying to, you know, glorify your own self, man. You know, if anyone's going to praise you, it's going to be, you know, other people's, man. We're not even looking for that as a thing, man.
Yeah, Yahushua said what? He that exalteth himself shall be abased.
Yeah.
He that humbleth himself shall be exalted.
Yeah, that's what he said next to him.
So, go ahead.
Verse 7, you got it, huh?
Yeah, you got it.
But whosoever exalted himself shall be abased.
That's right.
And he that humbleth himself shall be exalted.
Yeah. So, it's not about exalting oneself, man, you know, deceiving your own self, you know, pride, man. You know, that's all that, man. It's all about being humble.
Yeah, because when the lights go out, when the YouTube stops, the internet stops, and all of this stops, what the fuck is that? WTF? What is all that gonna do for you? You know, when the shit hits the fan, what is all that gonna do for you, man? All the vainglory, gonna do nothing for you, man.
What the scripture say? Many great mysteries come upon those that
dwell in
great pride.
Yep. And that's one thing that the Lord hates, right?
Yeah.
You know, that's the beginning of the separation from the Most High.
Yeah.
The Lord dealing with the lowly, man. The scripture said that the secrets are revealed to the meek.
Yeah, the scriptures that say pride is hateful to the Most High man.
Yeah.
When you have a pride person, no one likes a pride person.
Yeah.
You know, that fool himself.
He can't tell him nothing.
Right.
Dude can't take no correction, none of that, man. I got a few now.
Yeah, go.
It's Luke 10 and 16. He that heareth you, heareth me. And he that despiseth you, despiseth me. And he that despiseth me, despiseth him that sent me.
Yeah, Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, he didn't come for the entire world, man. You know, there's a remnant, you know, a chosen. All right, you know, everyone else is gonna, like the scriptures say, man, despise what he has to say.
But I'm building around these guys that are puffed up.
Yeah.
You know, these novices that think they're somebody. You ain't despising Apostle Har, Apostle Bar, Apostle Rama, Apostle Raka, on down. You're not despising these men. You're really despising the Lord.
Yeah.
Okay? Because it's Yahweh Hashem Al-Shai that has positioned these men, you know, in these high seats, man. Okay? And they're doing a great job at what the Lord set them up to do, man.
Yeah.
They're doing a great job. You can't say nothing against these men.
Scary.
You know, it's just really you guys are envious and jealous of these men. That's what it is.
Hey, just like the scribes and Pharisees, they were really jealous of the house.
They didn't want to lose their seat.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right, but the scripture say what? We entered into other men's labors, man.
Yeah.
Who the hell are we? You know?
We're just servants.
What were you doing in 1990?
I was a
What were you doing in 1985?
Right.
What were you doing in 2000? You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
These men were laboring, man.
Yeah.
Where the? Here I go with the F word. Where were y'all in 9/11, man?
Yeah.
When Esau captured these men and tried these men in the courts, where were y'all at? You know, that's how you gotta come at Jake.
Yeah.
They don't want you.
That motherfucker is in your diapers, man. Suck on your mama's titties.
This is Matthew's 23, and we start at 1.
The whole chapter the Lord was going in.
Right?
Hey, everything got an exclamation mark at it. He was chewing you wicked Jake's out, man.
Man.
I was like, yeah, that's
easy. I'm like, how we signed to the multitude and to his disciples saying, the scribes and Pharisees
sit in Moses' seat. Okay? They put that high position, man.
Yeah.
Okay? All therefore, whatsoever they bid you, observe. That observe and do.
Right, because what were they telling you to do? To keep the law.
Yeah.
Which that is good. That's the right thing to do.
Yeah.
We're telling Jake to keep the law to the best of your ability.
Yeah.
Because it ain't all about the law. All right, the scripture speaks of the law of faith.
It says, but do not ye after their works.
Right, because they were hypocrites. Yeah. Their actions weren't lining up with their speech.
It's like you have men nowadays, man, you know, their first thing it's to go to the law, man. Say, you know, that, you know, most of them even say they're saved by the law, man. You know, which that's wickedness in itself, like the brother was going into, man. There's grace and mercy because of what Yahweh Shai sacrificed did.
I believe it's that same chapter where Yahweh Shai said they admit. how does it go?
Oh, they admitted these three things, yeah. Judgment, yeah. Mercy, and faith, you know?
He says, for they say and do not, for they bind heavy burdens and grievous to be borne, and lay them on man's shoulders, but they themselves would not move them with one of their fingers.
Right. But they act as if they're not, they don't have that inward battle, you know, like they're keeping the law 100.
It's
not, man. You know,
the scripture said that our righteousness is as filthy rags, man. You know, we're not going to get 100% perfect. We strive to it, but none of us have it. You know?
I got to. You can see that same thing with these other camps.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, yeah, do what they say, like keep them low.
Yeah.
But don't follow what they do, man. Because they off, man.
Yeah. Because you know what the scripture say about men prophesying with hats on, with their head covered. Okay?
I wouldn't be surprised if dudes was sparking up before they left me.
Exactly.
They be looking dusty like they sparked up, man. Hey. You know when somebody smokes weed, they look all dusty and dirty, man.
And there's a scripture in Sirach where it pretty much says there's one that teaches, you know, wise things, but it, you know, of understanding, but it's a profitable to his own self. You know, that applies to a lot of men that are out there, man. You know, teaching these scriptures, teaching you about your law, the heritage, but you know, they're not really keeping what's in it. All right.
It says, for they bind heavy burdens, I'll grab that. It says, but they themselves would not move with one fingers, but all their works they do for to be seen of men.
Like marching around the damn Brooklyn Barclays Center, man.
Yeah.
Like, what is that? What is that? How is that edifying?
Right.
But you want to be seen by men.
Right.
Look at our numbers. You know?
But the true prophecies and the things that's going to matter in the people's lives, you going totally against the MOTB. You going totally against that, man. What the hell is that?
That's right. You can't even deny that anymore. It's plain. You know, that's the only plausible device concerning that prophecy. What else can you put there? People try to connect the juicy juice with that. You didn't need it. You wasn't buying anything with the juicy juice.
Right.
They used that for you to have access to certain things, but you wasn't using that to purchase them. The MOTB, you're going to have that to make any purchase, to have any functions in society, man.
Yeah.
We're not there yet.
Hey, that's why these same men that were denying it at first, they're saying not to take it, man. And they're doing that wicked shit where they're saying you could still repent. No, there's no repenting after taking that, man. You know, like it says in Revelation 14 and 9, man, you're going to burn if you take that, man.
Hey, Yahweh Shemel Shah is not the author of confusion. If it was sin, the Lord would have been like, it's sin.
Yeah.
You know?
It's a sin to take it.
Yeah, it's a sin to take
it.
But
it's not the act of sin. That's not what that mark was referring to. That's a physical device. Like brother's been saying, I'm sorry, brother. Like brother's been saying, like you hear the apostles say all the time, if it was sin, we're all doomed.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're all doomed, man.
Yeah. It represents your allegiance to the devil, right?
Yeah.
Esau.
You're going
to send your faith. Yahweh Shai. you're serving Esau when you take that mark.
Yep. And you can't say that you haven't sinned. What the scriptures say about that? Any man saying that he has sinned, have not sinned, he's lying.
Huh? Right, that's pretty much saying that they haven't sinned.
Right.
Okay.
It says they make broad their phylacteries and enlarge the borders of their garments.
Galatians 6 and 12. It says, as many as desire to make a fair show in the flesh, they constrain you to be circumcised, only lest they should suffer persecution because of Yahweh Shai. And neither they themselves who are circumcised keep the law, but desire to have you circumcised, that they may glory in your flesh. Okay?
Yeah, I made him do that. I'm the one who did that.
It's about the circumcision of the heart.
Yep.
I mean, I'm over here touching my... it's about getting your spirit right. Y'all brothers understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, of course, yeah.
It's about getting your spirit right, man. Paul, he broke it down in the book of Romans. A Jew is one inwardly, man.
Yeah.
You know, it's better to align yourself with the word, you know, and have faith in the Lord and not be circumcised than to be a circumcised nigga, man.
Yeah. Hey, that's why it says Revelation 2 and 6, 9. They be synergized, those that say that Jesus are not, but be the synergized to see you.
Right.
Yeah, what Shai said, they want to be seen of men. And they want to be in that top seat.
Yeah.
Oh, I did this, I did that.
Yeah.
That's what it's about to say.
Second Esdras chapter 14 and verse 13. Now therefore set thine house in order and reprove thy people, comfort such of them as be in trouble, and now renounce corruption.
Now, before that starts with your physical household, man, that starts, you know, with oneself, like the brother was going into, man. It's about getting your spirit right. All right, before you're out there, you know, teaching and correcting your people, man, you got to make sure you're following what is, you know, written here, man. Obeying what Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is written here.
What that makes you look like?
A hypocrite, man. Like the brothers going into, man, these scribes and these Pharisees.
All of that is still triggered
says, and love the uppermost rooms at feast and the chief seats in the synagogue.
Yo, they were looking good, man. If you go into it, the scribes and Pharisees, they're looking good. They're under the Romans. Okay? The Romans allowed them to be in that position. And that's another thing. That's why they were envious of Yahweh Shai. They were afraid that they'll lose that position again.
It says, and greetings in the market, and to be called of men, Rabbi, Rabbi.
Hey, like the IRC castle. Here comes
Nice, right?
So, and everyone, you walking in like it's a goddamn NBA game.
That's not good, man. Dude, men exalting themselves. It's weird. The Lord's not with that, man.
Yeah.
You know, scriptures say, I'm sorry, bro. Scriptures say, for men to seek out their own glory, that's not glory, man.
Yeah. You gotta let other men glorify you.
The other men praise him.
Yeah.
Yeah, like Yahweh Shai said in that prayer, man. He's sitting at the lowest seat, man, you know, and he calls you to a higher seat, man. It's about, you know, having those other men tell you that. You gotta stop saying my bad, bro.
Yeah.
It's all good, brother.
No, good.
Romans 2 and 25. For circumcision verily profiteth if thou keep the law. But if thou be a breaker of the law, that circumcision is made uncircumcision. Therefore, if the uncircumcision keep the righteousness of the law, right? Like you got some brothers that are uncircumcised, but yet they believe in the Lord, right? Therefore, if the uncircumcision keep the righteousness of the law, shall not his uncircumcision
be counted for circumcision, and shall not uncircumcision, which is by nature, if it fulfill the law, judge thee who by the letter, and circumcision that's transgressed the law. For he is not a Jew, which is one outwardly, neither is that circumcision, which is outward in the flesh, but he is a Jew, which is one inwardly, and circumcision is that of the heart in the spirit, and not in the letter, whose praise is not of men, but of the Most High. All right, so it's about getting your spirit right, most importantly, man. It's about faith in the Lord, most importantly, man. You know?
Most important, yeah.
But get circumcised if you can.
Yeah, that's part of showing your faith in the Lord.
Yeah, that's something that you can do on the side.
Yeah, it's possible.
Get it done before they outlaw it, man.
Hey, because you be making money. I mean, let's say you be blessing all this money, buying bullshit, buying all this, but you don't have enough money to get circumcised.
Yeah, you should be putting money away for that. Being diligent towards that. Then you don't want to miss that blessing of the Messiah. Said the Lord about to slay Moses because he didn't circumcise his son.
Be not a hypocrite in the sight of men, and take good heed without speaking, because this word is like an two-edged sword. What you say can come back to cut you. You gotta, whatever you say, you gotta apply it to yourself first and foremost.
Two-edged sword, man.
Right.
That sword is swinging both ways.
Verse 30. Exalt not thyself, lest thou fall and bring dishonor upon thy soul.
Yep.
And so the Most High discover thy secrets and cast thee down in the midst of the congregation.
All right, because the Lord knows your true intentions.
Yeah,
you know, you gotta come in this thing in fear of the Lord and truth and sincerity, man.
Right.
Why the Most High chose King David to be the king? Okay? Because King David was a man after his own heart, man.
Right?
All right? The Lord knew his mind. He wasn't concerned about his other brothers, how tall and how strong they were, like Samuel was. Then this has got to be the king, you know? But now the Most High was looking at the soul, the spirit, man. That's what matters.
Well, that was Moses.
Right.
Yeah.
Hey, because Moses was known as what, Tazapanya? He was known as what? He was known as...
Come on, brother. You got to try, brother.
He had a good speech? He was a good speecher? I mean, good talker?
He was humble.
Yeah,
he was known
as the most
humblest
man at that time.
Hey, but you gotta try, bro. Right when we ask you, bro, you automatically, I don't know. You gotta think about it, bro.
Noah. Okay? Meek. Okay? The Lord deal with the meek. He don't deal with men all puffed up. You know, like you did something of your own. You didn't do anything, man. You didn't even wake yourself up this morning. The Lord woke you up.
Yep.
Okay? You bragging is about stuff that you have no control over.
That's why.
Okay?
And all things gotta remember to give glory to the people. Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai.
Sirach 10 and 12. The beginning of pride is when one departs from the Most High.
That's it, man. Because you leave off from your power source. You leave off from acknowledging the Lord. All your ways. Now you think you got the juice. No?
It's like a phone disconnected from the charger. It's eventually gonna die.
It's like this American woman. I don't need no man. Mm-hmm. You know, that's pride.
And the scriptures say the more knowledge you get, the more humble you should get, man. You should humble yourself more. The more knowledge you get, humble yourself down. Be more of a servant than trying to be a master.
Hey, that's the king. That's what the king's supposed to set up for. The king's not just exalting himself. I'm the king. The king's set to serve the people.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
That's what King Solomon prayed for, man. You know, the wisdom to how to rule his people, man. You know, like the brother said.
Yeah.
Beginning of pride is when one departs from the Most High, and his heart is turned away from his maker. For pride is the beginning of sin. and he that hath it shall pour out abomination. And therefore,
pride goeth before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall, man.
Like America. America's full of pride.
So it should always be humble, man. You know, it should always be, humility should always be the only option, man.
And like when you drive down Santa Monica Boulevard, okay, if the pride is just it's oozing out.
Yeah.
Okay, right?
Yeah. That city's destroyed. It's not the same no more.
It's done.
You can't, like, it's like turning into downtown LA.
Yeah.
It's literally turning into downtown LA.
Yeah.
They're like the homeless from Venice Beach is moving down to the city.
You know, you go on Santa Monica Boulevard.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. The Boulevard is different from the city.
Right.
The Boulevard, you going through Hollywood, you going through West Hollywood, you know?
Yeah.
So I'm not sure what you're talking about. What are you talking
well,
about?
Well, I'm saying the pride over there is like
West Hollywood?
No.
It's basically you know the whole of Santa Monica.
We talking about the city.
The street.
Okay.
The street of Santa Monica.
The whole city. On the beach.
I'm sorry.
But that
Boulevard goes all the way to
the city. I know it's
right.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
In West, like Westwood, I believe.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Over in that area, they got signs and rainbow flags, everything. The whole.
You're talking about West Hollywood.
Yeah, West Hollywood.
You're talking about
okay.
West Hollywood. They got the crosswalks.
Right, the crosswalks. Yeah. They got lights up.
Yeah.
And they change all to the rainbow color and all this shit. You know, the pride is, and they got the word pride written. Okay. So it's exceedingly high, okay? And they think that they've got they think they've gotten the victory, man.
Oh, just wait.
Yeah, it can happen this year.
Lord willing, I'm tired of this prideful.
Every aspect of this place is horrible.
For pride is the beginning of sin, and he that hath it shall pour out abomination. And therefore the Lord brought upon them strange calamities and overthrew them utterly. The Lord had cast down the thrones of proud princes and set up the meek in their stead.
Hey, here's an example. Nebuchadnezzar, his pride, he got lifted up even towards heaven. So what the Lord did, turn his ass into a beast, man.
Boy, even Pharaoh.
Man.
Yeah. Esau, the scripture say what? The pride of thy heart hath deceived thee. Thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rocks. The Lord carried you that. He pumped you up like that. Just so your ass can get punched down.
So the things written before time were written for our learning, man. You're supposed to be learning from these acts of pride. And don't get caught up in that. Okay?
Oh, what's that?
Dark. Who was that king that would not listen? And then the Lord had him to where his sons got killed.
Zedekiah.
That was in Isaiah.
That's the last image he saw was his son. He probably, the scripture's gonna tell you, but he probably will have dear, deep love for his son.
Yeah. I mean, that's natural, bro.
Yeah.
The Lord have plucked up the roots of proud nations and fed the lonely in their place.
What you think he's gonna do to America? Oh, I got F-15. America never gonna be invaded. No one's gonna mess with us. We're America. Whoever messed with America, all these generals with their proud speeches, man, all that's gonna come to naught, man. Okay? Clock you.
Lord overthrew countries of the heathen and destroyed them to the foundations of the earth. He took some of them away and destroyed them and has made their memorial to cease from the earth.
What do you think the Lord, again?
Some more. All
right.
Pride is not made for men, nor furious anger for them that are born of a woman.
Right, because the scriptures say what? The Heavenly Father is the high and lofty. You know what I'm saying? What do we have to be proud about? The scriptures say what? Why is Asher a
Why is earth and ashes proud?
Verse 9. Back up, way up. Why is earth and ashes proud?
Right, earth and ashes. What are we made out of?
Earth,
man.
What are you going back to?
Earth, dust.
Ashes.
Ashes, right? What'd they say? Dust, ashes.
Exactly.
So why is earth and ashes proud? Speaking of the man on earth. What do we have to be proud about?
Right.
The scripture said, the Lord humbleth himself to look at his creation.
Yeah. You don't know when you're coming in. You don't know when you're going out. Yeah. You don't know when your conscience was abating, when you start to consciously observe to know that you're, I'm here. Like this brother said, I'm a man, I'm a boy. You don't know anything. Okay, so why are you proud?
Even when you do know, when you begin to understand, you still ain't controlling that.
Right, yeah. Exactly.
You're just on the ride.
Even that wisdom, that faith, man, all that is a gift, like the brothers are going into. Hey. You know, that was given to us.
Paul said, why act like you didn't receive it?
Exactly. From Corinthians. Yeah.
Like you were saying, you don't know when you're coming in, you don't know when you're going out. Mm-hmm. Just like over there in Turkey, it's 20,000 plus people.
Oh, hell yeah.
They didn't know they was going to die that day.
Man, it keeps going up.
Yeah.
And Lord's will, man, it comes over here, man. It's a big ass quake, man. The infrastructure here, man, you people are proud, man. These buildings will crash just as much, man.
Yeah.
All right? Shit could change just like that overnight.
Oh, yeah. You know, and those people were in their buildings, right? They were in the building. Some people brushing their teeth.
Some people sleeping. Having sex.
There you go. All of that. And then all of a sudden, the whole building come down on them. It's over.
That's scary.
Hey, California. Every time, like, with Texas, you know, the storm over there. Well, every time any storm, I always see California, like, on the comic board, I'll be reading the Instagram post. They'll be
talking shit.
Yeah, they'll be talking shit. I'm like, man, stop talking shit, because y'all don't know, man. You know what
this. You imagine an 8.0, and imagine, like, the high, what's some buildings called? Skyscrapers in downtown.
Oh.
You imagine that? Yeah. Them things will fall over,
Well, those, like, now, like, a lot of them are built with.
That don't mean nothing if the Lord went it down. That don't mean nothing, bro. He saw, let me try to, you know, make it to where it don't. Man, the Lord can knock that thing down, man.
Yeah.
Hey, that's pride. I understand. I feel you. That's pride, right?
Yeah, it's building a freaking building.
Yeah, you ain't gonna knock it down.
These buildings are on rollers, they say.
Hey, right. You said about the Titanic.
Yeah.
Right, exactly.
Sinkable. Lord sunk it.
I was just thinking that.
Tower of
the Bubble. Yeah.
Hey, what are you doing with that?
Can
I bring this up?
Yeah,
it links up what you were saying, right? So this is Isaiah 37:21. This is after you had a Syrian king named Sennacherib, king of Assyria. I'm going to pronounce it the best way I can, sloppy. So Isaiah 37:21. Then Isaiah, the son of Amos, sent unto Hezekiah, saying, thus saith the Lord, the power of Israel, whereas thou hast prayed unto me against Sennacherib, king of Assyria, this is the word which the Lord hath spoken concerning him. The virgin, the daughter of Zion, hath despised thee, and laughed thee to scorn. The daughter of Jerusalem hath shaken her head at thee. Whom hast thou reproached and blasphemed? And against whom hast thou exalted thy voice, and lifted up thine eyes on high? Even against the Holy One of Israel. By thy servants hast thou reproached the Lord, and hast said, by the multitude of my chariots am I come up to the height of the mountains, to the sides of Lebanon, and I will cut down the tall cedars thereof, and the choice fir trees thereof, and I'll enter into the height of the border in the forest of Carmel. I have digged and drunk water with the sole of my feet. Have I dried up all the rivers of the besieged places? And this is what King Sennacherib was. Yeah, I took down the nation. I did this. All right, right? So it says, and the Lord heard everything. Hast thou not heard long ago how I have done it, and of ancient times that I have formed it? Right, it was the Lord that sanctioned you to do those things. He gave you the military might to do those things. You didn't do it out of your own might, just like you Edomites, all right? He gave you the power to take Jake down and to have us in slavery. Okay, because we're far greater people than you. All right?
That's why the scripture said, shall I ask boast in itself?
Right.
I guess had that swing in it, you know?
Yep.
Because who's the Lord using to punish David? To punish these people for the iniquity. Some Edomites, man. Okay? But here it is, they God lifted up a great pride. What do you think the Lord's gonna do? Bring their pride down, man.
Yeah, the Lord. The Lord allowed them to win so much.
Right.
You've been able to really how do I say it, man? You know, the plans that you put together, you've been able to accomplish them.
Yeah.
Over time, you know? But it's, you don't understand that it's the Lord that is directing you to do so.
Right.
Okay?
I started out here long ago, how I have done it, and of ancient times that I have formed it, now have I brought it to pass, that thou shouldest be to lay waste, defend cities into ruinous heaps. Therefore, their inhabitants were of small power, they were dismayed and confounded, they were as the grass of the field, and as the green herb, as the grass on the housetops, and as corn blasted before it be grown up. But I know thy abode and thy going out, and thy coming in, and thy rage against me. Because thy rage against me and thy tumult is come up into my ears. Therefore I will put my hook into thy nose, and my bridle in thy lips, and I will turn thee back by the way which thou came. The point is, the Lord, he spoke wildly how he did this. He took down these nations. Okay? Now the Lord came and he defended you. Okay, because the Syrians, if you go into the history, they took down the tribe of Israel, I mean the northern kingdom, but they were really trying to take down the southern kingdom as well, but they couldn't. Alright, and it was all because the Lord was with the tribe of Judah. Alright, it was all because of David's sake. Okay, that's why you had all the northern kingdoms, their kings were wicked, but the southern kingdom, you had kings that were righteous and wicked and righteous. Okay?
That's
the king. Yeah, the king has a title.
Yep, this is Acts 12 and 21. And upon a set day, Herod, arrayed in royal apparel, sat upon his throne and made an oration unto them. And the people gave a shout, saying, it is the voice of a God and not of a man. And immediately the angel of the Lord smote him because he gave not the Most High the glory. And he was eaten of worms and gave up the spirit. Quick point. You know, he gave a great oration, and the people said it is a voice of a God instead of worship. Instead of giving praise to the Heavenly Father by Shimna Vashai, this dude, he ate it up. You know, he ate up the praise of the people. And the Lord had an angel smite him right there in that moment, man.
Shows you what? All glory should go to the Most
High. That's right. Yep. That's it. This is a quick example.
I got one too. This is Daniel 4:30. And this is Nebuchadnezzar. It says, 4:30, it says, the king spake and said, is not this great Babylon that I have built for the house of the kingdom by the might of my power?
Amen.
Hey, wait. What was Jeremiah telling his people the whole time, prophesying his people, that the Lord was going to set the Babylon school over them? So it wasn't him,
they had
it was
to go
the
to
Lord.
They had it.
Yep. Yeah. It says, and for the honor of my majesty, okay? It says, while the world was in the kingdom, while the world was in the king's mouth, there fell a voice from heaven saying, O King Nebuchadnezzar, to thee it is spoken, the kingdom is departed from thee, and they shall drive thee from men, and thy dwelling shall be with the beasts of the field, and they shall make thee to eat grass as oxen, and seven times shall pass over thee, until thou knowest that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men.
There you go.
And giveth it to whoever he will.
Hey, what movie reminds you of that? Emperor's New Groove.
It's a movie.
Yeah, it was an Egypt time, right?
Yeah.
No,
what I'm saying? But before it was a series, it was a movie.
Yeah, it was a movie. He was a king.
And he came out when he was like born, bro.
Huh? Yeah, I watched him when I was growing up.
Yeah, like talking shit, bro. Now, that was a real good one.
That's a good example. They probably, whoever made that movie, probably based it off that.
Right. He turned into a llama.
Yeah. Eating grass and shit.
Yeah. Remember El Dorado?
El Dorado, nah.
You don't remember El Dorado?
I don't remember that one.
You remember that one?
No, I don't remember.
Damn. Yeah. It's like the same like animation. Mm-hmm. You can tell it's the same artist.
I'll probably check it out when
I'm El Dorado. Don't sleep on them Disney movies.
Can you get me out of
Ezekiel? Oh, Ezekiel chapter 28, verse 1. And the word of the Lord came again unto me, saying, Son of man, say unto the prince of Tyrus, thus saith the Lord Yahweh, Bashim El Shai, because thine heart is lifted up, and thou hast said, I am a God, I sit in the seat of God.
Like they show you on the Xerxes on 300.
Yeah, he thought he was a God.
These kings always have that God complex, man.
Yeah.
And it says, lift it
See,
up.
But our kings don't have that. They didn't have that.
No.
They knew it was a greater power ruling everything, man.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
Hey, just like our apostles and elders, they don't have that.
Nah.
They don't have that kind of complex, man.
Nah.
Yeah, you go around them, it's just like being around regular men. They ain't exalting themselves, saying, hey, I got to sit here. I need to sit at the seat, at the head of the table, that type of stuff, man. They don't do that.
They still say the hopeful elect.
Right. They're still humble. They're still saying they hope that the Lord saved them, man. They're not, they've been in this thing almost 40 years, man. And they're not calling themselves the elect. They're not saying, yeah, I know I made it. I've been in here almost 40 years, so I know the Lord dealing with me. Okay? Why, yet you got guys spending 5-10 years and shit talking like, yeah, they know the deal.
Like the work is done.
Yeah.
Like you got a crown.
King Canute, I always remember Apostle Bar bringing out that story about how he had his royalties always praising him.
That's
how great, how king. Right.
Yeah,
so he said, can the ocean obey me? So yeah, ocean go obey my king. Mm. So as soon as he went to the ocean, he said, ocean stop, or something, right? And the ocean didn't stop. You know, because he was getting tired of all that flattery.
That's something that I've always observed, man. The sea is humbling. You know, you go to the shore, you go to the beach, you feel all that power, man.
Yeah.
It's like, wow.
You go to Laguna.
All them. Any.
I'm saying, I was referring to Laguna. It was like, I feel like I was in a goddamn washing machine, man.
Hey, you want to fear the Lord? Go to that spot right there.
Y'all went to Treasure Island, man. I think y'all went there. Y'all just don't know it.
Yeah.
Because I experienced the same thing.
Yeah.
I think y'all went there. You just don't know.
Yeah, just walking out to the pier. Like, you're in the Santa Monica Pier. And then there's piers that, you know, you walk way out to the ocean. Just to the edge, you can just feel the power of the ocean.
Bro, that thing.
The depth of it. Imagine going way out in the sea, man.
Bro, we don't know what the sea can say.
Hey, it seems
that's a whole other world, bro.
It seems like the sea, like, got a spirit or something.
Sea world.
It's just power, bro.
Oh, yeah.
I got one, man. It's Jeremiah 5:22. Fear ye not me, saith the Lord. Will ye not tremble at my presence, which have placed the sand for the bound of the sea by a perpetual decree, that it cannot pass it?
Yeah, bro. I'd be at the ocean, bro. Big
ass waves, but they calm down by the time they get to that sand. Because they're following the commands of Yahweh Bashem El Shai.
They even crash.
That's what the scripture going to say.
Yeah, I see.
It says toss. It says, It says, fear not me, saith the Lord. Will you not tremble at my presence, which I have placed the sand for the bound of the sea by a perpetual decree, that it cannot pass it? And though the waves thereof toss themselves, yet can they not prevail. Though they roar, yet can they not pass over it. You know?
Yeah, it's like when you go to the beach, you can actually see it. Like the water hitting the sand, and crashing upon itself.
Yeah.
It's like almost like an invisible law, like stopping it.
Yeah. It's that command, that decree.
Yeah.
And you can pressure the ocean. Like you go down deep, yeah. You feel crushed metal, pressure. But yet you got little thin fish that can survive it.
Hey, like Leviathan.
Yeah, I was thinking about it.
When you go into the word, it's basically what's joint? Scales are very joined together. That's how they go live down in the ocean. I got some that links up with that. Psalms 104:9. Thou has set a bound that they may not pass over. Psalms 104:9. Thou hast set a bound that they might not pass over, that they turn not again to cover the earth. And what is that talking about? The flood. I mean the ocean, the water. Okay? Because at one time when the Lord floods the earth, he opened that decree to allow the waters to flood the earth, man. Okay? But now he put that bound that they cannot pass. So every time you go to the ocean, right? Every time you go to the ocean, you see that. You see it. And people still don't believe that it's God. How can you explain that? Explain that. Because I tried to look it up. What Esau says about it. I wasn't even going to say it. What he said about it. I didn't really find no information.
The Lord split the Red Sea.
Yeah.
Okay? That ultimately showed his power over the water, man. Okay? He could make the water go both ways. Okay? And make a wall. And then dry the land up.
The ground is dry, yeah. Watch that Prince of Egypt, man.
Yeah, I watched that. That was a good movie.
That's a great movie, y'all. That's a classic. Once again, at Disney, man.
Yeah, it's going wrong. I don't know about anymore, but.
Not anymore.
Continuing at Ezekiel 28, verse 2. Again, Son of Man, say unto the prince of Tyrus.
Hey, Selachia. Another scripture too, he mentioned controlling the water. Remember Yahushua calmed the sea.
Oh yeah.
You know, that was like even the
seas obey.
The sea obeys,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So it's just backing your point up.
Right,
can you imagine that?
Yeah.
That's like that movie Avatar. Not the blue dudes, but
Avatar.
The airbender, you know?
Yeah.
Controlling the elements.
Yeah, his disciples were scared that night, I believe.
Yeah, because they thought they seen a spirit. Woke him up. He said, "Well, where's your faith, man?
Yeah, I'm sleeping. You think it's gonna happen?"
Right.
Yeah. Precious cargo.
Yo, that's crazy. Yeah, I was like, right. You know, sleep during that storm, you know?
Right.
Hey, because being in the storm, I've never really been in there, but just off observation, not something I would want to be in.
Bro, a storm on land is some shit.
Yeah.
When the waves are tossing you and stuff, I'm good, man.
Fell land, man.
But if you with the Lord,
yeah.
That would be my comfort, man. The Lord right here, man. Chill out. But they went to him though. That's what you do.
Yeah.
We run to the Lord through our prayer. If he there, I'm going to him. I'm running to him.
Exactly.
I'm waking you up, Lord. Look, Lord.
Hey, like
some things happening out here that you probably need to pay attention to.
Hey, look, you put a guy shipping his apartment.
Dwelling.
Hey. Like,
that's right, though.
That's spiritual representation, how we're about to go through the storm. We got to believe that Yahushua is with us. Even though we don't see him, but he's with us spiritually.
Yes,
we get us through the storm.
Yeah, it's good to say the present help.
Right.
That's a beautiful story, because like the brothers are going into, man, if the Lord is with us, who can be against us at the end of the day, man? You got to believe that he's going to help you. And if you're doing all you can, then, you know, to serve him, you know? But, yeah.
Ezekiel 28 and verse 2, Son of Man, say unto the prince of Tyrus, Thus saith the Lord, Yahweh Shimei Shai, because thine heart is lifted up, and thou hast said, I am a God. I sit in the seat of God, in the midst of the seas. Yet thou art a man and not God.
That's how Esau thinks, man. You know, he thinks himself to be like the Most High, man, which he's not, man. Like the scriptures say, man, you know, he was the weapon that was formed, you know, against the wicked of our people, man. Alright? That's why he was created.
Thou set thine heart as the heart of Yahweh, behold, thou art wiser than Daniel. There is no secret that they can hide from thee.
And that wisdom and the knowledge you have, man, that was all given to you by the Lord. Alright? Every single bit of it, man.
And he knows how to manipulate weather, he knows how to start earthquakes.
Hey, control the weather, and through the Temanites, man, you know, he made the nukes, man. You know, and that's in the scriptures, man. You know, he created it.
Like the heart. Yeah. You're saying the weather. Yeah. You see, Turkey saw the before the earthquake. There's a video of a flashlight just weirdly appearing out of nowhere.
And sound too, like that machine.
You know what's crazy? All of a sudden, now they have I've been seeing articles about Nikola's earthquake machine. Nikola, Tesla's earthquake machine.
Oh,
how he had a machine that was able to basically cause an earthquake to shake the whole building, shake the whole bridge. And that was back then, man. Technology is much far more advanced.
Oh, right. Hey. Who ultimately is doing it?
It's the Lord.
The Lord. Yeah. Hey. The Lord killed him. He's staying at 21,000.
Yeah.
Before I came back to LA and stuff, you know, I had to start getting to the truth. I moved over to Indianapolis, right?
Yeah.
And one day it was a storm, right?
Oh, I think you told me this.
Yeah, this storm was so intense that the thunder sounded like it came from under the house. It was so basic, right? And at that same time, the lightning came in the kitchen. The blinds were down. It was about this much room under the window, right? The lightning came through the window.
Wow.
Came and hit me right here in the chest, right before it got to my chest. It just stopped right here at my chest. It was like click right here. And a voice came to my head and said, you know I can kill you right now. Like that, and my son was in the other room. I asked him, I said, did you feel that? He was like, yeah. I was like, what happened? I was like, did you get struck? He's like, yes. He's like, yeah. I was like, where? He said, my chest. He was in the other room, though. Got him and me. Okay? But it came right here. I saw it. It was like right here. Right to my chest. Okay? It came down to a little point. It was like, click. And the voice came to my head, like, you know, I can hear you right now. You know?
For the Lord, man.
So the Lord controls everything, man.
That thunder be rumbling.
Bro, that was the scariest. That was the scariest sound I ever heard.
That'll wake you up, you know?
Yeah.
That thunder ain't no joke. You don't want to be caught outside with that. I got one going back to the sea, though. Real quick. It's Psalm 89 and 8. Or you know what, 7. The Most High is greatly to be feared in the assembly of the saints, and to be had in reverence of all them that are about him. O Lord, Yahweh Shemel Shai, God of hosts, who is a strong Lord like unto thee, or to thy faithfulness round about thee. Thou rulest the raging of the sea. When the waters thereof arise, thou stillest them. You know, just back up that point.
Right.
You know, the Lord rules the raging of the sea. That's why 2 Exodus, the 13th chapter, it tells you that when it goes into the northern kingdom coming over here, it tells you, Lord, I forget how it's worded.
He calmed down.
Because there's some turbulent waters down there.
Yeah.
So the Lord calmed all that down and made a path for Jake, man.
Showing that it was the Lord's will for them to come over here.
Yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Just like he made it possible for ugly-ass Columbus to get over here.
Yeah. Yep.
You know?
So enduring Jacob's trouble, that's why he said he shall be saved out of it. Because the terrible times is going to come. Okay?
The Lord's going to calm it down in your and you for you.
Right.
You know?
That's badass.
Not calm it down for everyone, but calm it down for you where you're fed, you're protected from the poor, you're protected from the pestilence. You have no need to worry about it. You and your house. If it's destined for them to be safe.
Yep.
Seeking the Lord, all you meek of the earth, which have brought his judgment, seek righteousness, seek meekness. It may be you shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger.
There you go.
And seek the Lord what now while you may be found, man. Alright, seek favor right now, man. Right now is a grace period. Alright, there's going to be a time where that runs out, man, where you're not able to see the prophets out here, man, where you're not able to go on YouTube and see these videos.
Seek righteousness, seek meekness.
Yes.
Yeah. Let go of that pride.
Right?
Yeah. That's how I get you out of there.
Yeah.
So things are speeding up, man. Yeah. And, okay. Prophecies upon prophecies are happening.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's like a conglomerate of things happening at one time.
Hey, judgment all around the world is
all
happening.
Around.
Well, remember the scripture says it's gonna be like a woman in travail. You know, the plagues are not slack.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Them contractions begin to hit harder and
more
quicker.
Yeah.
So that's what we're experiencing.
Yeah.
Things are happening back to back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, here it is, 21,000 dead and gone.
Woo!
Man.
It says it goes into earthquake, famines, and it says wars, these are all the beginning of sorrow. Going to that, it goes into
birth pains. NLT, when you go into the NLT, these are the beginning of the birth pains.
Yeah, that's
Matthew 24:8.
Yeah.
I got that scripture you read in NLT. It says, Zephaniah 2:3 NLT. Seek the Lord, all who are humble, and follow his commands. Seek to do what is right and to live humbly. Perhaps even yet the Lord will protect you from his anger on that day of destruction. So being hid is the Lord protecting you, man. Straight up. Just like he protected our forefathers, man. Just like they weren't affected by those 10 plagues in Egypt. The Lord protected them. So it's an election on the earth that are going to be protected when the Lord begins to bring this destruction, man. Ultimately being delivered from the nuclear destruction that's promised to America, man. You know?
But you still gotta move with that sense of urgency of that fear, man, of the Lord, man. Alright, nothing is guaranteed, like it says in that in the NLT. Perhaps you might be saved. Alright?
Yeah, it all comes down to faith.
Yeah.
It all comes down to the mercy of the Lord. The Lord will have mercy on whom we have mercy. Well, all we can do is try, man.
Yeah.
Shit. I'd rather try than not try.
Hell yeah.
You know? And if it comes down to you not making it, hey, just what the Lord didn't choose you, man. But shit, I'd rather walk in fear while we on this earth than to walk out here in sin, man. Doing whatever, man.
Hey, Ecclesiastes 8:12. I know it's better for them than those that fear the Lord than those that, you know, continue in sin.
Yeah.
That's a paraphrase.
Yeah. So you that endure a bunch of the head, saying you shall be saved. And be comforted by those words.
Sirach 51 and verse 7. They compassed me on every side, and there was no man to help me. And I looked for a succor of men, but there was none. Then thought I upon thy mercy, O Lord, and upon the acts of old, how thou deliverest such as wait for thee, and savest them out of the hands of their enemies. Then I lifted up my supplication from the earth and prayed for deliverance.
That faith, it's got to be there, man. You got to be entertaining these righteous thoughts of salvation.
Right.
Always, man, no matter how grim the situation looks, man. Hey, you got all these stories that are written of old, like it says in the scriptures. All right, were these men not delivered out? You know, you got to ask yourself this, man.
Think of Daniel, the lion's den, think of three holy children.
I love that. I love all the accounts, man. You know, I love them, man.
Everything you read aforetime, written for our learning.
It's like when you read it, it's like you read it for the first time.
Every time.
It's like watching a movie over and over, but it's like new every time you read it, every time you see it.
You always probably see something new, learn something new. So
a word, you know, a word might hit you a different way in a moment.
Yeah.
You know, it's like,
that's why this book, this Bible is a never-ending book to read.
Right, you know, it's a lot of focus, right? I put a lot of focus on how we're dealing with Daniel and the lion's den. What's the name of the king? Was it Darius? I forget, but
always. Yeah, I think so.
He said, Daniel, the God that thou serve continually, man.
Yeah.
I love that part, man.
Right.
Because we serve Yahweh by Shemel Shai continually, man. You got to have confidence in that, man.
No matter what happens, like it says in Romans 8:35, man, who shall separate you from the love of the Most High?
Right.
You got to be serving the Lord continually, though, man. You know, and the Lord will come through for you, man.
Yeah.
The Lord will, Daniel said, the Lord sent an angel to stop the mouths of the lions. The Lord will send the angels to do things for you, man. Straight up, man. Straight up, man. Them angels is out here, you know, through the commands of the Lord for the election's service, man. You know, just like the Lord sent an angel to Peter in the prison, man.
Yeah.
And straight walked him out. It was surreal. It was like, real right there?
Yeah.
Then it finally hit him like, damn.
Man,
Lord sent his angel to deliver me from prison, man.
Yeah.
Hey, they say the truth is stranger than
fiction. Facts. There's things I still think about and praise the Lord on things that he done for me, man. It's you know, they got that emoji with the mind blown?
Right.
Yeah. I be feeling like that, man. Like, ah.
I'm confident.
Boy,
I think back on my life, bro, so many things I just like, I'm like, man, there's just no words to even explain it.
And I use that for my confidence because I'm not looking to myself to deliver myself out of it. I ain't called on Satan.
Right.
I didn't call on no God or no Jesus. I called on the names of Yahweh Bashima Rashai. And the Lord delivered me, man. So I use that to fuel my faith, man. Like I called on the Lord, and he came through for me, man. So how much more is he going to come through for us in that hour, man? When we really need the Lord, man. When we get cut off from this system, man, we're about to be cut off from the system. They about to outcast us, man.
Yeah.
She was walking like that last time. I'm saying like no shoes.
Verse 10. I called upon the Lord, the Father of my Lord, Yahweh Shemel Shai, that he would not leave me in the days of my trouble, and in the time of the proud, when there was no help. I will praise thy name continually, and will sing praise with thanksgiving. And so my prayer was heard. For thou savest me from destruction, and deliverest me from the evil time. Therefore will I give thanks, praise thee, bless thy name, O Yahweh Shemel Shai.
That's right.
Yeah. Always, man, it's always about praising Yahweh Shemel Shai, always. All right, no matter what.
It's like grinding teeth, right? Last week he said, what did he say, man? He said, he said, I forget how he worded it, man. You know what I mean? People don't know the name of the Lord, something like that. And he was like, but you do!
Right.
He was like, you know how many people don't know the right name of something like that?
Yeah.
We got the right names of Yahweh Shemel Shai. We got the correct names. We got the right number, the right address.
Special.
You know how precious that is? You know?
We have God's special.
Jeremiah 9:25. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will punish all them which are circumcised with the uncircumcised. So know, the ones that keep the law and the ones that know that they're Israel, they know the name, but
that's
they,
dealing with the heathen, bro.
Punish them just like he's gonna punish 2/3 of our people.
That's done with the heathen, bro.
Yeah.
You sure? Yeah, bro.
Yeah, because look, but read the next verse.
Yeah. And it says that Jake aligned themselves up with what the heathen is doing, man.
Yeah. Oh. And then also when the
you can't just say anything.
When we had the Syrians attacking Israel, you had Jake that always went to seek Egypt for help, for rescue.
Okay.
Wow.
We should do it right now, okay? Because the counsel of the Lord is coming before all these things that are happening. There's counsel, okay? The Lord sent his men already to counsel you on what's happening, all right? But our people don't want to take the counsel of the Lord. They want to take the counsel of the devil, man. Their adversary, okay? The one who's proven time and time again that he means them no harm. I mean, no good. Okay?
Yeah, that's why it says in the scripture, man, though the wicked join hand in hand, man, you know, the wicked will not go with punishment. You know? Hey, man, judgment is coming for all.
Our people still don't want Esau to get judged for the things that he's done. Okay? And continues to do.
That's why they need to die.
Yeah.
That's why.
That's the only solution.
For Esau. We want Esau to get punished. When Esau gets punished, your ass will get punished with him as well.
You want him to be your God forever, man.
Yeah,
you know, that's who you trusted, man. You trusted men.
Hey, because they were the same people that were in the wilderness that wanted to go back to Egypt.
Yeah.
And put themselves back in slavery, man.
That also says in the scripture, man, you know, when you trust in men, that's going to be a snare to you, man.
Right. Trusting in this world.
All through that's why 2/3 of our people have to die, man.
Yeah.
Both sides not going to save all Israel like he did back in Egypt. Those are people are just far too gone.
And that's why not all Israel's our brothers.
Yeah.
You know,
right,
Jake.
What's that cast them off the
heathen, right? Mm-hmm. Jake always concerned about my brothers, well, if they don't do the work, they're not your brothers.
That's what Yahweh Shai said.
If they're not if we're not walking together in righteousness, sincerity, and truth of serving Yahweh, blessing Yahweh Shai, they're not our brothers. Right?
Hey, Yahweh Shai said that about his mother and his father.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what I'm saying? His own parents, he's like, well, who's my mother, who's my father? Those that do the will of Yahweh Hashem,
yeah.
Okay?
So that's why you can't be too concerned with 2/3 of these chicks out here that just can't get it.
Yeah.
Jews that come up to the camp, scoffing, they want to push their own logic, their own doctrine on you, trying to teach you, man, the hell with you, man.
Yeah.
The Brandon team coming up, man, casting.
Hey, it got to the point where the Lord straight up told Jeremiah not to cry for nothing but pray for these people, man. Ask these people, man. They're going
to die. Hey, because every time Jake come out, they always see the concern about the other nation. They're concerned about the people.
Yeah.
You know?
The nation.
You got it, bro.
At the end of the day, they're just comfortable here in Babylon. Babylon the Great. They don't want to give up their lives, man. They don't want to see this place destroyed. They receive the consolation.
You know? That's right.
Hey, this is what it is. We gotta go. Hey, we can't wait. You know?
Yeah, well, you can't deal with all Jake, man. That's why
all dude out.
Yeah. That's why two-thirds are going to be destroyed, like it's going to say.
Yeah.
Zechariah 13 and 8. That's your scripture now, brother. And it shall come to pass that all the land, said the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die, but the third shall be left therein. And that's what? 66.6% of you Jakes here in America. All right? The ones that you, that are uncircumcised like the heathen, with the heathen, right? You subscribe to this man's ways, the Lord will take you out. Yeah. Okay? And that's why you hear it say two-thirds or one-third. Okay? Because the Lord's going to save one-third of Israel here in America, man. But he's going to destroy two-thirds, man. That's a lot of Jakes.
Right. And they're the main ones that always say what? Only God can judge me. They're the ones that say that.
Don't go with your wish for.
Well, the Lord judging you every day.
Amen, but you don't want to be judged.
You know what I'm saying? The Lord is judging Jake every day, man. Judgment is going out every day on you, Jake.
They don't see it as judgment. They don't see it. They just see it as life or the universe punishing you for not acknowledging that there's a God that's actually doing these things.
Right.
Yeah, they really are saying the universe.
Right.
Yeah. We're tired of that. Hearing
put
that.
Put this out in the universe.
Who created the universe?
Fuck out of here,
who
man.
Created the universe, huh?
They can't even tell you what universe means.
People in this world are going to learn of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai,
right.
But they're going to learn it the hard way.
That's right. It says, and it shall come to pass in that, it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die, but the third shall be left therein. And I will bring the third part through the fire, and will refine them as silver is refined, and will try them as gold is tried.
And so that fire, that goes into the affliction, the hell that we got to catch for the Lord. All right, in order to be perfected, like it's saying, it's precious metals, the gold and the silver. It's to draw out all those impurities in us, right?
We're going to that fire right now.
And we're going to actually be, saved from the fire.
There's two different fires that you either can go through. You got to choose.
We're really in your choice.
Right. Fire of affliction or literally fire. I got something after you.
What the Lord say? What was it John the Baptist that said?
You shall flee.
He shall baptize you with water.
Oh, yeah.
With
fire.
Okay. It says, they shall call on my name, and I will hear them.
The name there.
Just like freaking Brandon T, punk ass. Yeah. What's the name of the Most High, asshole?
Yeah. Oh, there y'all go with that.
Yeah, man. There you go with that.
It could be disputed.
Yeah, he kept saying that, right?
And, what he said, it's arguable.
Yeah.
It's arguable.
Whoa, the Lord has it. He says the Lord is a change.
Right.
The Lord is his name. When you look up the Lord in Hebrew, it says Yahweh. And his son, Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, man, he wouldn't answer it, man.
Exactly. But I told him, I was like, how many truths is it? It's only one.
What's going on, brother? Oh, you got to hear it. You can't hear it, huh? Yeah. I'm saying, he didn't look like he's very. He has a question or something.
No, he's
I can hear it. Okay.
He's
quite deaf. It says, they shall call on my name, and I will hear them. I will say, it is my people. And they shall say, the Lord is my God. Yahweh Bashim Yahushua. How's it going, man? How you doing?
I told you.
What? Yeah, you didn't finish what you're saying.
So, choose today who you're going to serve, man. It's either you're going to serve the Lord or this world, man, this bad, this white man. All right, one is going to lead to your destruction, and one is going to lead to deliverance.
And this word is so cold. The Lord has this word going out silently.
Yeah.
So even if, you would be edified.
Yeah.
I got some
subtitles.
Yeah, subtitles, yeah. Ain't no subtitles in real life, though.
I got some.
You got the sign, though. He can read, right? He can read. He's really he's really trying to understand. He can't hear it, but he's really trying to see it.
Abba, where are people?
Yeah, they're with the Israelites. City. Yeah, with the Israelites.
Nice.
Okay.
Look at that.
See, he really was. But I'm pretty sure he can read.
Abba.
You didn't say nothing, bro.
What? I was trying to tell you he was all there.
Yeah, I mean, we can see that. But he still was like on it, though.
Yeah.
He was on it, bro. I mean, hopefully he read the sign.
Yeah.
But I didn't know his pops over there.
I got something. Ezekiel 20 and 17. And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, the house of Israel is to me become dross. All they are brass, tin, and iron, and lead in the midst of the furnace, they even the dross of silver. When you look up dross is like considered something that's worthless.
Unwanted.
Right. So, and that sounds like, you know, you got stuff like that that's on silver. And how do you take that off? You have to burn it up in the furnace. Okay? Verse 19. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God, Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, because ye are all become dross, behold, therefore I will gather you in the midst of Jerusalem, as they gather silver and brass, and iron and lead and tin into the midst of the furnace, to blow the fire upon it, to melt it, so will I gather you in my anger, in my fury, and I will leave you there and melt you. Yeah, I will gather you and blow upon you in the fire of my wrath, and ye shall be melted in the midst thereof.
How is that going to happen? A lot of these Jakes are going to be caught up in the destruction that the Lord promised Babylon the Great. Hey, read Revelation 18 chapter.
You have a DOL meter, which basically is a meter that measures pain. So like, for example, if you get a paper cut, that's like 2 DOL. If you get shot, that's 43. You get kidney stones, 50. Pregnant. Woman that's pregnant, the pain up to 7. But the worst one yet is being burnt alive, which is 7. Which that's just regular fire. How much more the fire that Yahweh Bashim Yahushai is going to bring?
You said pain of burnt is 57?
Yeah, 57.
Pain.
That's a hell of a
curse.
Right. And getting kicked in the nuts at like, perfectly, about 52. But
that shit goes straight to your stomach, man.
Right. But being burnt alive is worse.
Yeah.
And that's what this is about to bring. That's that second death that you Jake's about to suffer, man. The 2/3, man.
It ain't just the net. You know how people get, on fire. They might be in a car and being burned alive. It's going to be worse than that.
Yeah.
You're going to feel it to your core.
Yeah, right. It's going to be. It ain't just a regular fire, man.
Remember,
so you can put that number up.
Yeah,
to 100,
to 1,000,
to 1,000.
Yeah, there's really no number. That like, breaks the ceiling, bro.
Yeah.
Set records. Yeah. Being put in the fire, and he say, like to make the fire hotter.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that even burnt the men that try to put them in there.
Exactly. Okay. So you know the hottest fire burn blue. Okay, like that fire on your stove, that gas fire, the bottom of it is deep blue, and as it gets toward the top, it gets orange, and then it gets white at the tips. Okay, you gonna be in that blue fire.
Like you watch Avatar the Last Airbender, the top fire was when they shot lightning, they had that blue fire.
Yeah,
they shot regular fire, but we got that blue fire coming out of, oh shit.
Yeah,
I'm gonna smoke with you.
That's gonna make you look like a lake from the top. Looking down on it.
Yeah, that's why it's known as what? The fire.
Yeah.
So the Lord's going to purify his people. It just depends on how he's going to purify you.
Yeah.
Is it going to be the word? Yeah. The truth? That fire?
Yeah. Hey, I'd
rather have it. It's
better if it'll be his word.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Fire.
Because it is a fearful thing to fall into the hand of the living power, man. No one can save you. You can't be delivered. Okay, once the Lord sets his sights on you and sets you out for destruction, especially that nuclear fire, man, it's going to be over for you, man. Okay, all the repenting and all that thing, all the things you wish, I wish, that's going to be nothing, man. The Lord ain't going to hear nothing. Okay, it's just like when your mom finally gets mad enough to put that strap to your butt, and then all of a sudden you want to recant on everything, you want to say, I'm sorry, I ain't gonna do it. The first thing you say is, I ain't gonna do it no more. Yeah. In her words is, what? I know you ain't gonna do it no more.
each word is a whoop.
Exactly.
Big pop.
So that's how. Say you're gonna do it no more, but eventually you're gonna do it again.
Right.
It's like the book of Judges. Most of us have to put that.
Yeah.
Well, really, the Lord won't have to change us.
Yeah.
That's really what it comes down to. Take that sin out of us.
Yeah.
Give us that new heart. So we just be on point, man.
Yeah.
So where there's no need for wrath. There's no need for anger. The Lord said he ain't gonna be angry forever.
Hey, that's why the Lord knew what he was doing. That's why he multiplied his mercy.
And that's why them curses came first.
Yeah.
This is the last time we're gonna feel like this shit.
Yeah.
Hey. Thou Jerusalem, thou shalt no more be carried away into captivity.
He's gonna say no more death, no more sorrow, no more pain.
Yeah.
That's gonna be the thing of the past.
Hey, what causes to be put in captivity? Our sins. Our hard-headed, being hard-headed and stubborn.
What caused us to die?
Sin.
Sin.
Because sin is, there you go.
Sin is our kryptonite.
Yeah, that's our weakness, and Mother Nation know it. That's why, like Batman, he is Superman's kryptonite. He managed to get it.
Yeah.
To bring Superman down. Batman is like, he's like Esau, you know?
Yeah. Batman is whack, bro. He's just like billionaire toys and stuff.
He's also devil, man.
That Dark Knight was hot, though.
Yeah, well,
that's the best Batman ever.
Which one?
I like Dark Knight.
Oh, yeah.
Nah, that's not what Bane.
Dark Knight Rises is hard.
That's what Bane.
Yeah, that's what's hard, bro.
Nah, the one with what's his name? Heath Ledger.
No, the one with Bane. I like the one with Bane.
Bane was tight.
Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 24. Oh Lord, correct me, but with judgment, not in thine anger, lest thou bring me to nothing.
That's what we ask of the Lord, you know? Like the scripture says, we're casting and judging the Lord now, so we won't be judged with the world.
Yeah.
You know, we feeling a different type of wrath. You know, our wrath is chastisement, which is love.
Yeah.
I mean, the wrath, not the wrath, not our wrath. But we're feeling a chastisement, which is mercy and love, right? So we won't be judged with the world, which is wrath.
Yeah.
You know, like the Lord, he ain't dealing with you. You don't want to hear none of that. He gonna kill your ass, man. We don't want none of that.
That same sentiment is repeated in the book of Micah, man. Where he says, there they were patient with the Lord, so he freed his cross, man. So we're gonna catch, you know, the help, you know, that's placed on us, because that's ultimately what's, you know, gonna help us at the end.
Yeah, it's hard at times, you know.
Yeah, and like it says in Hebrews, no chastening for the present, see, but to rejoice.
Rejoice, it ain't good.
Yeah, it sucks some days, man. Some days you just don't want to fucking be here, but hey, there's still plenty, you know, work to be done.
Still got a mission to complete.
Yeah.
In them last days, you know, a brother's gonna consider like, damn, I'm happy the Lord brought me through. You know, I was catching hell like this instead of what people are going through now.
Yeah.
You know, getting dying from plagues, eating each other, right out there.
You're
gonna reflect on like, damn, why the Lord put me through those things instead of being.
We do that now.
Yeah, instead of being in the day of evil, getting punished.
I see a homeless man like, oh fuck, damn. Out.
The hardening too, though. The hardening that the Lord is doing with us. He's making us tough, man, mentally, you know? The Lord got us, like, you know, these people out here are soft.
Yeah.
They're like jello,
soft,
man.
Any little thing they can slide. All emotion.
I had to tell a dude at my job, man, to start panicking over a situation. I'm like, look, man, you gotta keep your composure, man. Even if you might be going through a lot up here, you gotta keep that poker face, man.
Yeah.
What was the situation?
You know?
Yeah,
you always gotta remain positive. Alright, like it says in the scripture, man, this wisdom and knowledge is what's gonna keep you stable, man. While everyone's bugging the hell out, man.
I had to train, this is what I'll give you. I had to train the person that was replacing him. So he came into work, finding out that he's being replaced. You know what I mean? And he just like starts shaking and heathen them, you know?
That's why.
Yeah, it's like, I see how weak he was, you know?
Even the weak.
Yeah.
And that's why you can't have that worry and doubt, man, like it says in Timothy, man. He didn't give us the spirit of fear, man.
And it still kept him up to die. That's funny.
last day, you know?
Well, we saw him do that shit. Like, getting laid off.
Saw scaling, huh?
Yeah. You know, you don't have to train the person that's placed you. He's placing you.
Yeah. It's a cold world, man.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that's why jobs don't deserve all the money.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, man. It's all about yourself, man.
If you die, they gonna hire somebody the next day.
Yeah,
that man was, he was probably wondering how he's gonna provide for his family. You know, like that. You know, hey, when shit happens, man, you gotta have trust in the Lord at the very end of the day.
All day, every day.
That's all we can turn to.
Nah, for real, though.
Yeah.
For real, though. We don't have, what do we have, man? You know, all we have is the Most High. I always tell y'all about your Most High. All I have is you.
Yeah. All I always have. Say that, what I always say. That's all we need.
That's all we need.
We have the ultimate help.
Right. The ultimate.
So, you know, told my woman that I got the ultimate help.
Yeah. Well, that's why I listen to. Don't fear it. Don't fear those that. There'll be many more that be with us than with them that are with them.
You got to remember, too, that the Lord, he declared the ending. He already knows what's about to happen. Before it happens, he knows. He's already 10 steps or how many other steps in
infinity.
Infinity of steps in front of you, preparing your way. Okay?
Yeah, bro. Let me bring this out, man. Because I always think of the scripture, man. I got to bring it out.
Yeah, our help is the one that created the situation.
Right.
Yeah.
Exactly.
He's the one that put us in there.
Yeah. And we're being tested. Jeremiah 10:23, I'm gonna read the KJV and NLT. It says, "O Lord, I know that the way of man is not in himself. It is not in man that walketh to direct his steps," right? The NLT says, "I know, Lord, that our lives are not our own. We are not able to plan our own course." Alright, so we are not able to plan our own course. Our course have already been planned for us.
Yeah.
Backing you up, but you said, the Lord is infinity steps ahead, alright? Yeah. So the Lord already knows your course. He already knew 3 years ago that you was gonna be met with this certain trial.
Yeah.
You know? So you gotta have faith that everything's gonna work out, man. You got to, man.
I got a piece of just going right real quick, you know this is my favorite scripture.
Yeah, what you got?
Proverbs 20:24.
Okay.
Man's goings are of the Lord. And how about Shem Yahweh Shai? How can a man then understand his own way?
Yeah, you gotta get the NLT on that one too.
Okay,
you won't be able to understand your own way.
That's why in the morning you can map out what you're gonna do next, but it's all on the Lord, man, that decides what's gonna happen.
Last Saturday, I'm like, I'm gonna go to class, I'm gonna go to do this. Turn into my car, couldn't fucking turn.
Exactly.
That's 2024.
Yeah.
Alright, so in the NLT of Proverbs 20:24, the Lord directs our steps, so why try to understand everything along the way?
You gotta let go and let the Lord, man.
You know what's best?
Hey, I've been talking to y'all about something. I'm sorry like that, man. I might not understand it, but I know you're directing me. You know better than me.
Doctor, way higher than mine. You got the world.
You got to pour it out, man.
That's walking with the Lord.
That's walking with the Lord.
Because you're constantly in connection. You're constantly talking to the Lord all day.
And constantly engaging with the Lord.
Constantly.
Acknowledging all your ways. Even with jobs, like, I've been noticing, like the Lord is guiding me to find my job, go here. Oh, shit, there you go.
Yep.
Exactly. Hey, talk to this guy, he'll help you out. In my mind,
that happened to me at my job, bro. Yeah. I actually had pressed the burglary button, right? Cops came, all that shit, right? This is when I first started working this job. But through that situation, it made me tight with somebody I need to be tight with at that job.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying? So I will feel of certain benefits. You know, knowing this guy.
Right.
So I understand why the Lord had me press that button.
I got a piece of it. Psalms 4:4. Behold, the Most High, Yahweh Shimei Shai, is my helper. the Lord is with them that uphold my soul. Mm. So the Lord is our helper, man, in all situations. He's always guiding us in our day-to-day life, man. He's always, not just in the spirit, but just when you're out doing your daily thing, doing what you need to do, man. He's guiding you. You may be driving, and sometimes you may take the long way, but you don't realize it, But it's the Lord that guides you, man.
I got a new thing I always say right now, because I've been driving a lot. And the thing I say is, there's no wrong turns. No wrong turns. Oh, I missed that turn. That wasn't wrong. The Lord made you miss that turn. Okay?
Yeah.
Every turn that you make, the Lord is the one directing your steps. Job, 1:8? Lord said the man slumbered that night, put his head on his pillow.
He
sealeth the instructions, man, for the next day. Okay, so you're already, when you're laying in your bed, you're programmed for the next morning already. Okay?
That's why you have deja vu. You feel like you have deja vu because you basically remember what the Lord implanted. But a long time ago, I remember I had a dream. My dog was in my neighbor's yard, and one day I went to go for my dog, and I couldn't find my dog. I was like, where the hell my dog is? And she must have ran out the house, all right? And I walk out, and she's in my neighbor's yard. Well, I got a precept.
The Lord telling you
where
the dog is.
Jeremiah 10:23.
Oh
Lord, I know that the way of man is not in himself. It is not in man that walk into directed steps. Okay. But Lord, he's the one that's directing your steps, whether you realize it or not. You just gotta trust in the Lord, Even if it doesn't even work out your way or how you wanted it to work out. Okay, or it may take, or your plans may take longer than expected. All right, there's a reason for that, man. You gotta trust the Lord, trust the process. Like Joel Embiid said, trust the process.
Just accept it, man.
Every time I gotta explain to my father, like, I have no control, or the Lord has control. He's like, why you ain't got kids? Why you ain't got a family? And all this. It's hard to explain to them, like, I can't.
I'll be like, why are you asking me this?
It's hard to explain to my father, like, look, the Lord's in control.
Proverbs 27:1, boast not thyself of tomorrow, for thou knowest not what a day may bring forth. You don't know what tomorrow's going to bring, man.
Yeah. You don't know if you're going to live tomorrow.
Right? Yeah, it can very well be good.
You know what can happen. That's why you got to just live focused day by day.
That's it.
Not make plans, I'm going to do this for 10 years and all that, like these American people do. Day by day, focus on getting daily bread, focus on doing the work of your house, busting your house. That's all that matters. We're not here to try to make it in this world. We're just here existing. I'm a fucking parcel. We're trying to maintain, so survive, whatever way we can.
Yeah. Alright, like me teaching jump board, that was already set up.
Yeah.
It was already set up.
Hey, I have back in the day, when I was working at this car dealership, I got a check for a bonus, right? Christmas bonus for like $1,500, right?
I got $1,500 or something, right?
The next day my transmission went out and shit. It cost $1,500 to get that shit fixed.
There you go.
Okay? That's the Lord, man. He knew it. Okay?
Just in time.
Why didn't the transmission go out the day before that? Okay? Come on, man.
$1,500.
Yeah. I was like, okay, this is it, but I wasn't thinking about spending it because I knew I was like, okay, why I get this money? Yeah. Why I get this money? What's this money for?
That's how you get it. I get a lot of money on it. I wouldn't go on a shopping spree. I just save it, man.
Yeah, save it, man.
There's a reason why.
Right? Exactly. Okay? There's a reason why. You got to listen to the spirit, man. See what's actually going on, man. If you listen, you'll see that the Lord is talking to you in every
aspect of your life and all day, everything.
That's that 144. Okay. See, 144, that's more like typical. Yeah, short tummy something.
Yeah. Periods.
You may mess up. You may sin, but then you see 144. Yeah. You ask Lord for forgiveness. Lord, forgive me. Have mercy upon me for this. And a few moments later, or when you say amen, you see 444, you know?
You always see it. Yeah, you always see it when you need it too.
Yeah.
Right. Driving down and going for something through the day. You know, something going on at work, whatever. Boom, that's my fair place to 144 hit.
And that's crazy because a lot of these people, they put these motivation quotes in the scriptures.
Yeah.
That's what they're created for. You get to have to drive, to run into us, and for us to see it. That's the purpose here on earth. You know?
Yeah.
Because a lot of these, like scripture says, 2 Corinthians 9:22, right? It says that a lot of these people are born in vain.
Yeah.
Let me get this before you get that out.
Go ahead.
And this one, license plate that said, had the letter Y, and then E, and then Y.
Y-E-Y.
Exactly.
What's that mean?
Y-E-E. Why you do it? Why?
Oh, Y-E-Y. I thought you said Y-E-Y.
Y-E-Y.
Because the Lord, that's why.
Right.
That's how the Lord made it. Yeah, this 2 Corinthians, going back to the signs. 2 Corinthians 1:3. Blessed be the Heavenly Father, even the Father of our Lord, Yahushua, the Father of mercies, and the God of all comfort. Who comforted us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of the Most High. So the Lord is God of all comfort, right? You know, I try to say this to 144, four chariots.
Five,
I was driving the other night, right? I'm thinking about, you know, certain shit I'm dealing with right now. And the license plate said, look to him. You know, look to him,
man.
You know, while I'm in mid-thought, you know, I look to my left on the freeway. Oh shit! Look to him, you know, on the license. And right. We know who the him is, you know. You know, deep mystery, you know.
Right.
It's the Most High. How about Shimon Shah, man?
Yeah, it's a trip. Yeah.
Go ahead, bro.
This might be the Truman Show where he kept seeing signs.
That's
a good movie, man.
They were putting messages
towards
to him.
So messages, you gotta take
them. That's one of my favorite comedians right there. Mm-hmm. That dude, goofy as hell. You know that dude's from Canada, right?
Oh, is he?
No, I was gonna say, it's a trip, man. You know, over the years, man, throughout your life, man, the Lord has always been there, man. You know, brothers are saying, you know, their signs, brothers have testimonies, all kinds of things, man. And that's why, you know, whenever we need any kind of help, man, we turn to the help action. Yeah. Shy always.
I got 2 scriptures.
Hey, brother, I got one.
So Psalms 46:1. The Most High, Yahweh Shemel Shai, is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.
Present help, man. You know, hey, sometimes it will happen where everything works out instantaneously.
Yep.
And that was the Lord then.
Everything falls right in place.
Yeah.
You know? Wisdom of Solomon 19:22. For in all things, O Lord, thou didst magnify thy people and glorify them. Neither didst thou lightly regard them, but didst assist them in every time and place.
Yeah.
And who's the Lord dealing with right now? The Israel of the Most High. The Israel of God, the elect. So he's assisting us in every time and in every place, man.
Guardian angel. It's been with you your entire life. You know? Some of this truth you start to realize, like what was going into it, past experiences that you couldn't really explain.
Yeah.
Now you can explain it.
Right?
Now you understand it.
Now your eyes open.
Yeah.
Psalms 43:5. Why art thou cast down, O my soul? Why art thou disquieted within me? Hope in the Most High. For I shall yet praise him, who is the help of my countenance and my power. Yeah. Sometimes you do get disquieted, man. You do feel sad. You do feel down.
And we're in the flesh, man. We get weak, man. Right. Everyone gets weak.
It's like how we shot. Yeah. What did the Lord do? He said angels, they're strengthening you.
Yeah.
Same thing for us. The Lord has angels that strengthen us. We give them a brother. We do a lesson. We can keep these signs. You know? You know? The Lord, he's our comfort. We should always look to him. See to him, man. In all things, even in the good times, man. Crazy how Hashem Shai that he allowed you to have a good time. He blessed you with a good time, whatever that good time is.
That's what you do at the most. You know, when you're so-called prospering and stuff, it's like for us, everything with the money, that's when you get to thank the Most High as well. Everybody wants to go to the Most High when they're down, when they're going through something. Give thanks and praise the Most High when you're up.
Yeah.
Yep. Job said himself, we shall be not receive good on the Most High, not evil. In both things, we give thanks. Like I said in 1 Thessalonians, give thanks always.
Yep, always.
Always.
Because the evil things that the Lord sent out to you, there's a lesson in it.
Yeah.
There's a lesson you're supposed to be looking at. What the Lord is trying to tell me with this one right here. I got to look deep into this. You know, I'm not just going to get mad and upset, you know, and start cursing the Lord. Why you do me like that?
You
know?
Why they do me that way?
Exactly.
You can't ask the Lord why you, you got to just endure it.
Exactly. Say, Lord, what are you trying to show me?
And it's just life too, man. It's just life, you know. That's the arrangement of life. You gonna have the ups and the downs.
Yeah, there's gotta be that balance.
Valleys and peaks.
You can't always be that high because you're never gonna appreciate it. Yeah, you can't always be high, because when you're low, you're never gonna appreciate it that much.
Yeah, you don't know that person. You don't know if you're that mistake.
Yeah.
Right. Well, mercy is what makes you strong. It's what strengthens your mind.
And then when I see that,
that's why Paul said, he know how to both abound, be abound and abase.
Yeah.
You gotta know how to serve the Almighty Smell Shot for the good and the bad.
Yeah.
Luke chapter 11 and verse 9. And I say unto you, ask, it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find.
Now, like that brother was going into earlier, man, it's important to talk to the Lord, man, when you're going through it with anything, man, to build up that connection, man. All right, you know, he's who we ask of, you know, whenever we need something, man, anything.
Hey, this brother said he's a present help in a time of affliction. He think of someone being present, they're there.
Yeah. Hey, just like he was with the three homies.
Say.
Hey. Just like when the three holy children were put in the furnace, man, you know, hey, Yahweh Shai, he was there, man. So just like when we go through the afflictions, man, he's there with us, man. You gotta believe that.
Yeah, that's why it's important too to talk to the Lord even when you're not going through anything.
Yeah,
always, man. Every day.
Just talking to the Lord, bro.
All the time.
He's right there. He's right there.
Yeah.
Why you not talking to him? He's right there always.
Always.
You know what I'm saying?
He's waiting for you to call him.
Yeah.
What's that song? Y'all don't know that song, huh?
Y'all don't
know that Tiki song? It's you know that song?
Nope.
Okay. It's Hebrews 13 and 15. By him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to the Most High continually, that is, the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. Okay? So you're supposed to be praising Yahweh Hashem El Shai always, man, continually.
You never go
giving
far enough.
Thanks. Yeah, man. If somebody was following us with cameras on there all day, they would see that we always praising Yahweh Hashem El Shai, man.
Yeah.
We always giving thanks, man, for Yahweh Hashem El Shai. Always praising you.
I remember watching like a quick clip from that one podcast with Joe Rogan. He was talking to this Muslim fighter and shit. He was pretty much amazed, you know, how he, you know, someone like him, you know, he prays like six times a day or something like that over there in the religion. And he was like, oh, how do you do that, this and that? And it's just like, it's just crazy, like you're saying, that brothers is just like natural.
Yeah, man, we acknowledge our power. That's how you do it.
Yeah. And people look at you like that, man, you know, a little bit of base, like what?
We don't even keep count.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
And like you said, like a couple of camps ago, he's like, we're just doing We're doing for a little bit. The stats is in there.
We're angels keeping the stats.
We ain't keeping track of the stats, you know?
Say, when you wake up in the morning, first thing you do is thank the Lord. You know what I'm saying?
Then you're like, damn, another fucking day, man.
I got two alarms, two different things.
Luke 11 and verse 9. And I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asks it, receive it. And he that seek it, find it.
Hey, so it's all a matter of asking. It's all about, you know, praying for it. You know, like I say, man, everyone that asks it, to receive. The Lord isn't going to look at you and deny you, man. If you're asking it sincerely, no, genuinely. All right, continue.
And it says, and he shall find, knock, and it shall be opened unto you. Everyone that asks it, receive it. And he that seek it, find it. And to him that knock it, it shall be opened.
Yeah, especially if you're asking for things like wisdom, strength, faith, understanding, help. Hope.
You know, you ask the Lord for help.
Yeah.
Ask the Lord to strengthen you. You know, you ask the Lord for fortitude, patience, faith.
Hey, this is Psalm 87. Yeah. That's what all men should have, you know?
And it says, if a man asks bread of any of you that is a father, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks a fish, will he for a fish give him a serpent?
Amen. Hey, man, hey, Hashem Yahushua, he loves us, man. So he knows what we need, man. He sees us struggling. You know, and he's going to help us, you know, in our time of need. Alright? Just like a, you know, father, you know, down here on this earth, man, he helps you when you're going through it, man. And that's the same thing with the Lord.
Okay, I thought it was Brother Spit. So,
oh, wait, what's up, man?
Hey, we out here sometimes it just spit. It just get on you, man. So you spray peppermint?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. What'd you spray it on? Oh, okay.
It
says, or if he asks an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? If he being evil know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give you the Holy Spirit to them that ask him?
Yeah, right, being in the flesh, that's the evil, you know, being in the flesh. You know how to give good gifts to your seeds. How much more the heavenly Father to the ones he loves? Keep going. Oh, he said the Holy Spirit, my bad.
Yeah. He says, how much more your heavenly Father give you the Holy Spirit to them that ask him?
Nope. I got one.
It's Philippians 4:6. Be careful for nothing, but everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. Let your requests be made known unto the Most High.
Yeah.
You know, so you gotta let the Lord know what you need, man.
Even though he may already know it, man.
Yeah, he knows.
You gotta go out and put it forth out there.
Let your requests be made known.
Yeah. Like the saying in the world, that closed mouths don't get fed. Right?
Yeah, how do you expect to get help if you don't say anything?
You gotta ask for the Lord, Lord, I need you. Please make a way for me to escape this. You know? Instead of taking matters into your own hand, thinking you can deliver yourself out of it.
Yeah, man. That's how I make an ace. It's out of trouble.
That's good, man. Looking out, making rash decisions. Nah, man.
And that's always bad, bro.
Yeah.
You don't hate these decisions.
That's how women are, bro.
Yeah, you gotta think.
They get all emotional. Make do some shit they're gonna regret later.
They call the police on you, not meaning, but they just do it because they're emotional. And the next thing you know, you're in a spiritual war.
And the day that bitch called the police on you is the day that relationship ends.
Yeah.
Do I ever be with a bitch that would call the cops on you? It's like for my speech. Do I ever be with a woman that would call the cops on you? Cannot trust that woman.
Jeremiah 16 and 19, and it says,
always, yeah, make your request be done, man. No, man, it's always about calling, you know, calling Yahweh HaShem Yahweh Shai, man. But without wavering, man, always with that faith, man, and that belief that, hey, man, if it's meant for you, you're going to receive it.
Right. Okay. You got to have faith that your prayer is being heard, so.
Yeah.
Stay tight. Keep up in there. It's like you're talking to yourself, shit. But we do it so much, you know?
Yeah.
You can make it seem like, man, the Lord ain't hearing you out, man.
Hey,
nah, but
know.
The Lord is hearing us, man.
That's how you know he's hearing you.
Because
right,
he's
talking
to you. You got that resistance.
Gotta have some type of resistance.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
I got some. Psalms 34:15. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open unto their cry. It's like the prayers of the righteous pierce the clouds, man. The Lord has his eyes are open unto you, you know, always, ears, you know. Make your request known always.
Nahum 1:7, the Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble, and he knoweth them that trust in him. And the Lord knows who really, you know, believe and call upon him daily.
And with the fire will just determine who is who.
Yeah.
You know, the fire, when the Lord puts something on you, the fire is going to reveal your character, it's going to reveal if you truly believe, if you truly trust in the Lord, man.
I got some. Psalms 21. The Lord hears you in the day of trouble. The name of the Most High of Jacob, defend me. In the day of trouble, man, the Lord's going to hear you cry, man. He said before, he set up that trouble. The time of Jacob's trouble. The hour of temptation. Whatever situation you're going to go through in your personal life, man, the Lord is going to hear you in that day of trouble. See what the hell you're gonna do. You're gonna pray to him to seek a way out. Well, what are you gonna do? You know?
Hey, they have this thing in the world where they have somebody stand behind you and you do like a trust fall. You know, we're building like a relationship with the Lord, you know, learning how to trust him each and every day, more and more and more.
Facts.
Even to the last day, you know?
You gotta learn how to trust the Lord's timing too.
Yeah.
You know, you gotta trust the process, man. Quickly, man.
It's the Lord's time, you know?
I got one. I saw Psalms 99. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. And they that know thy name will put their trust in thee. For thou, Yahweh HaShem HaShai, has not forsaken them that seek thee.
Yeah, the Lord's never forsaken the righteous, man.
And the importance of the name, man. You know, who are you calling upon, man?
Right.
You know, we gotta know those names. Yahweh and Yahweh Shai. Right, that's who we call unto. And you know, like the brother saying, when anything good happens, when anything bad happens, you know, we call unto him.
That's right. Stand for a strong tower.
Yes.
Righteous running into it and are safe. You know, that reference to the brother just read about.
And bro, and that's why a lot of these people that don't acknowledge the name, they gonna lose. They never had to call upon the name for help, you know? When they call upon the name in that day, they're not going to expect anything to happen because
they never used it. They never knew the name.
Right,
they weren't taught it, you know?
Just like you got this phone right here, right? It's what's it called? Electric box?
Yeah.
Now, I remember on Matrix, right? They're running from the, what's the Smith? It's called Smiths?
Yeah.
They're running from the Smiths. What they have to do? They had to get to that phone, man.
That
line. You know, so we always trying to get to that phone. We got to get to that phone, man.
Always.
So for that safety, man, which is calling on the name of Yahweh HaShem HaShai. That's our refuge, man. You know?
I got something. This is Proverbs chapter 18. It's locked here, brother. Yeah. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous running into it and is safe. Proverbs 18:10. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous running into it and is safe.
Right.
That's the greatest defense we have, man. It's calling, you know, on Yahweh HaShem Yahweh Shai. All right. And that's what's going to keep us safe while, hey, what's coming, you, man, is bringing a time like no other, man. But when everyone else is losing it, man, we got the name to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. We got his guard, we got his protection.
It's Psalms 143 and 9. Deliver me, O Lord, from mine enemies. I flee unto thee to hide me.
Yeah, that's something, you know? Yeah. King David, man, you know, heavenly, man, whenever he went to battle, whenever he went to war, man, yo, he always called on Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai to see if this was the right move.
The righteous, the name of the Lord is a strong tower, the righteous come into it and it's safe. We flee unto the Lord, to hide us. We find safety in the Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, man. You know, that's whether that's from our enemies, that's from our daily troubles.
That's where you find peace, stability.
The Lord said what? John 16 and 33, in the world, shall have tribulation, but in me shall have peace.
Yeah.
Okay?
It's heavy. same things that we are, man. In the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, man. And it's simple, man. You can literally just, you know, it's in your fingertips, man. Break down all of it, man. These scriptures. All right, brothers, videos, man, uploaded on the daily. All right, there's no excuse. You know, when Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, he returns and he rains judgment on you people, man.
Yeah, that's how we're standing on our watch.
Yeah.
That's how you stand on your watch, man. Our teaching, videos, watching as well as praying, you know, watching what's going on around the world, watching these prophecies, watching for the signs of Yahweh Shai to this stuff. Look out for it, you know?
Yeah, because by doing that keeps your hopes up. You see these prophecies play out.
Yeah.
You see these signs actually happen. Yes. Yes. You're finding all these hopes.
Keeps that hope alive.
Yeah, that's why prophets are always saying that the reason why guys fall out is because they're not watching.
Yeah.
That's how you pay to the day.
So eagerly desire to see the second coming of our Lord Yahweh Shai. I remember one time, I was gonna say something else.
Go ahead, bro.
Huh?
Yeah.
Say it, bro.
No, it's because I remember one time, I was a little kid, and my dad said, we're gonna go to take Six Flags. I was so happy. He said, bro, I have to go somewhere. So the whole time, I was outside the window watching. Wait for him to come back. And every time you hear a car coming out, like, yes, one was there. My dad's here, but it won't be him.
You know? Did he go?
Yeah.
So he came. I remember I used to live in Redlands, first 90 years of my life. And, you know, my dad used to come through. At times, he would come through and, you know, take me back with him over here. And there's a lot of times, though, where I was waiting and he didn't come, you know? So I understand what you're saying. You know, I'll be at the window and shit. I was like six, you know? That shit used to break my heart, man. I seen that lesson too you did about whooping, you know, a child being whooped. You were talking about your dad and all that?
Yeah.
I didn't know all that, bro.
What? Oh.
Just your dad, you know?
John.
I believe you said 12 is 12, you know?
time, bro.
I've been listening to y'all, bro. Read that again. I got the NLT.
For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and
I see,
not lie.
That's what you did too on balance, bro.
Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry.
All right, that's why we have this much confidence. We able to bet on the future, man. Because these things are concrete. They're set in stone. They're going to happen.
Yeah.
As sure as the sun is going to come up tomorrow. As soon as the sun is going to go down, you know? It's NLT, Habakkuk 2 and 3. It says, this vision is for our future times. It describes the end, and it will be fulfilled. If it seems slow in coming, wait patiently, for it will surely take place. It will not be delayed. All right, so eventually that MOTB is going to be implemented. Eventually, chaos is going to ensue in the streets of America.
It's going to happen all at once, yeah.
It's going to be a famine. All right, there's going to be pestilence. It's going to be martial law. All right, people are going to be taking the concentration camps. Okay? Power most likely is going to be taken out.
This place is going to be invaded.
Invasion, war. All these things are going to happen. Uproars of the people.
Yeah. And these are the things that you people are not concerned about.
And these are not light things, bro. Not eating is not, it's not cool.
Nah. Yeah.
The scripture says it's better to die from the sword than to die of hunger, man.
That shows you how painful that it is.
Bro, that's an agonizing death, bro.
Yeah, like you've seen those cartoon shows where they're in the desert and they see like a haystack and they think it's a steak.
Yeah,
they're hallucinating.
See somebody look like a chicken wing and shit.
Yeah, you're gonna start eating
getting water.
You're gonna start eating your baby's arm like it's a chicken wing.
Because you begin to lose your mind.
Yeah.
You know? So the Lord gonna strip all comforts away from all you Americans, man. And what are you doing about it, man? The Lord's opening. The place of repentance is open up to your tribes, and you over here playing with it.
Playing games.
As if these things are not going to happen. These are promises, man, that the Lord made. You can look at him like that, you know?
He's not slack.
Yeah, he's not slack, man. They're going to happen. And for us that are waiting on these things, although it tarries, read that again.
It says, though it tarries.
Now read it from 3.
For the vision is yet for an appointed time.
Right.
But at the end it shall speak.
Right.
And not
at lie. At the end it shall speak means they're going to take place on earth. They're going to happen. And not lie. Go ahead.
Though it tarry, wait
right.
for it.
Though it delays, though it seems like it's never going to come, we're supposed to wait for it, man. And when you look into that word wait in the etymology line, it means to watch. Okay, so backing up y'all bros' points about watching, which is going to keep you focused on the times. It will show you, they're indicators of how close we are, man.
Right.
When the hell you hear 21,000 dead, man?
Exactly.
And rising, man.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Like people,
that's enough to make you clap.
When people are rushing to invade Ukraine, everybody was told by it, but we knew.
Yep.
That's part of the signs to watch out for.
Yep.
I wish I said, there's a war, it's rumors of war, but it seemed like majority of you people didn't read that.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because these things are hidden from you people, man.
Right.
The Lord got you distracted with lust, you know?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Hey,
you're
supposed to be watching.
Hey,
huh?
Hey.
Hey, watching the M.O.T. to the B, man.
Yeah.
Okay? Because sin was already here. You haven't watched the sin. Your sin is already here. Okay? But that M.O.T. to the B, it wasn't in the time of Yahweh Shai. But sin was. Okay? So we have to be watching for the things that are to come, man.
Right. But these people are not watching. Happening out for Zephaniah 2:15. This is the rejoicing city that dwelt carelessly. That said in her heart, I am, and there's none beside me. How has she become a desolation, a place for beasts to lie down in? Everyone that passes by her shall hiss and wag his hand.
Yeah, these people. Yeah, go ahead.
This is the these people are careless out here, man. I have no care in the world because here it is. You have war, turmoil. destruction happening all around them, but they don't care because it's not happening to them as yet, man.
But bro, tell me that's not the perfect setup.
Yeah, it is the perfect setup.
Because it's going to be that much more painful when these things happen for you people, man. Because you've been so damn weak. The flesh makes you weak, man.
Yep, and the things that are here makes you weak.
Yep, all the comfortabilities, all the technology.
Right.
That shit is breaking you down, man, making you weak.
Hey, like, for example, when you see the Creed, the second one, when he couldn't fought the Russian guy, he's like, Rocky's like, because he, basically, because he grew up hard.
Right.
He grew up in tough times.
Okay, you one where yourself,
you basically live comfortably.
Yeah.
You know, so you gotta go to a hard place.
Go back to the basics, right?
Right, go back, yeah.
Yeah.
A hard place. Okay? But America makes men and people weak here, man.
See, but that's why you gotta praise Yahweh by Shemal Shai. Because the Lord has put us in a hard place, right? The straight gate, right? What does it mean, huh? Straight. S-T-R-A-I-T.
Singular? Or straight line?
No, that's S-T-R-A-I-G-H-T. S-T-R-A-I-T.
Tip my tongue. Difficulties. Yeah.
There you go. There you fucking go. That's what I need to hear more, right?
Yeah, man. So the Lord, he brought us to that hard place. He's hardening us now. So when these things go down, shit, we're going to be like, all right, man, here we go.
Yeah.
It ain't going to be a new thing for us to call on the Lord. We've been calling on the Lord.
Exactly. Yeah.
The Lord ain't going to be like, man, who this? You know? Who this? Nah, the Lord, we calling on, we hitting that phone every day.
Yeah.
You know?
Hey, but America has desensitized people, you know, to certain things that's about to come.
Yeah.
Okay. People look at death like it's nothing.
Now,
okay. But when it start knocking on that front door, all right? Because the Lord has stepped up the game with that 21,000. Okay, he's stepping it up now. He's not using the low numbers no more. I was waiting for that day. I was like, this is gonna be a day the Lord's gonna start killing people in droves.
Wait till it comes to America, man.
Oh yeah.
Wait till the Lord do some devastation out here in America and it touches your life. To where you don't, you can't go to work because the motherfuckers that's slacking. The MFers that you work with are dead.
Yeah.
Their boss is dead.
Yeah.
Buildings destroyed.
Buildings destroyed. A lot of people gonna be displaced out here, man. You ain't gonna have no home. Wait till the Lord bring it, man.
Yeah. Wait till the one you're dependent on is dead, okay? Because you got a lot of dependent men, dependent on women, okay?
That's sad.
A lot of women dependent on their grandmama.
So children, bro, they're dependents. They're dependent on parents and grandparents.
Hey, like, play that game, home front, go in and kill the parents, and the kids start crying, you know what to do.
Like the movie The Road, it's him and his dad. And when his dad died, he was like, he was by himself.
That's how it ended,
yeah.
I got one. It's 2 Edges, 6 and 18. And it said, behold, the day has come that I will begin to draw nigh and to visit them that dwell upon the earth.
Ooh.
And that word visit means to inflict punishment upon. So the Lord's about to inflict punishment upon you Americans, man.
It's about to judge you. Yeah.
Mainly you tribes, you so-called Negroes, you Hispanics, and you Native Americans, man. And I did a lesson the other day. I taught them that if the Lord is not with you in that day, it's a wrap, man. It's a wrap for you tribes if you don't have the protection of Yahweh Shemal Shai, man. Because the things that are coming are unavoidable and impossible to get out of. Except you have the Lord on your side, man.
If you escape one, you're going to run into something else.
Even the scriptures say, Amos 5, yeah. I had mentioned that. Even for the elect, it's going to be a bumpy road, man.
Yeah. The Michael's going to have to stand up.
Right. So it's going to be a time like never before.
Yeah.
You know, you're going to see things that we've never seen before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the Lord is going to outdo himself with his destruction in the way that he can make you
the way he could terrorize you, man.
But even then, when we see these things unfold, we're going to have a place in our head to put it.
Right.
Like, man, all right, y'all, I smell so I got that happening. Yeah. The Lord got that happening. Oh, yeah. Snap, the Lord. We know the Lord in control, regardless. Apparitions, all of that.
Yeah.
Ooh. We understand who's controlling it all. So we have somewhere to go in our head. Stability, right?
Stability, yeah.
But the wicked, where they gonna go?
Right.
They don't have no idea what the hell's going on. They don't know what's next.
Yeah.
That's why Luke 21, it says they shall be perplexed. Perplexed means not knowing what to do.
Confused.
Yeah.
Not knowing where to turn. When you go into it, you don't know. Yeah. You don't know. Not knowing where to turn.
Yeah. Said, because instead of trying to come up against the truth and the apostles and the elders, these camps should be trying to teach about Jacob's trouble, the things about to come, man, okay? The things that really have an impact, okay, that's going to make a difference, man.
Yeah, that's Ezekiel 13. They're not gobbling in the walls of the water. They're not the doctrine. They're not teaching. They're not, it says in that same chapter, prepare the gaps. They're not preparing the congregation for what is to come.
Mm-hmm. Well, they're just a necessary evil, man. Fuck them.
Yep.
They're going to have to deal with the Lord at the end of the day,
man,
concerning the things that they teach. They're just going to die, really. You're going to die.
Yep, you did your job.
That's all it is. You're going to die. You're not going to be saved. You're going to die.
Right.
You got some?
Yeah, just go to
the second Ezra chapter 9, verse 1. And he answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the past, part of the signs past, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
And we're seeing those signs come to pass, man. Hey, that earthquake that hit Turkey, these wars and these rumors, of course, man. You know, it's all happening, man. You know, we're seeing that Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, he's about to return and bring judgment on the whole world. Or more importantly, these people that are in the sign, man.
Right.
Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world, then shalt thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. For like as all that is made in the world had a beginning and the end is manifest.
Yeah, so like we read in Habakkuk, the second chapter, man, the end is being made manifest. You know, it's written up even in the beginning. The Lord, man, you know, he already had everything in place. All right?
This brother said, when have you ever heard of 20 thousands of people just dying?
Still rising.
It's still rising.
At one time.
Let me look it up. I see how big.
A lot of spirits going back to the Heavenly Father.
That's a lot of spirits being judged. Alright, it's the Lord, man, that sanctions all of them.
So it's more compared to God here.
Yeah, you got one guy, here it is, he can hear his parents screaming for help. And he can't do nothing. They trapped in the rubble.
Yeah.
Cement and all type of debris and shit.
You got plenty of kids that were orphaned, man. You got that same thing. You know, it's crazy, man. You know, a whole ass family died and there was just a little girl in the rubble.
Yeah, you got people that they survived, but they were stuck for like 60 hours until they came and rescued them. Oh, yeah, you know how long that is?
Freezing cold.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah. It was also called freezing to death.
28,000.
Damn. 28,000.
Live update: over 28,000 dead from the quake in Turkey and Syria. More than 28,000 dead. 28,000?
Hey, people will never equate that to the Lord doing that. They'll say that's Mother Nature.
They actually say, when you look at the comments of people, when you see clips, pray for Turkey.
Pray for Turkey.
Pray for Turkey. And fuck Syria.
When you get Isaiah 29:6, right?
Yeah.
When the Lord said he's going to bring, what, earthquakes? You see, Isaiah 29:6.
Damn, 28,000, bro.
It says,
that's a lot of people.
Isaiah 29:6. Thou shalt be visited of the Lord of hosts with thunder, with earthquake, and with great noise, with storm and tempest, and the flame of devouring fire. And the multitude of all the nations that fight against Ariel, which Ariel is basically like another name for the city in David, it was another name for Jerusalem. Okay? But the point is, the multitude of all the nations that fought against Ariel, even all that fought against her and her mutation.
Does that break down to Ariala?
Lion
on the Most High.
Even all that fought against her and her mutation and that distress her shall be as a dream of a night vision, because you had Turkey, but during the time that when the Byzantine Empire was ruled 2,000 years, you had the Ottoman Turks, that took down the city constantly. Okay? So all these judgments coming upon these nations is for Israel. Come with the elect. With the Lord gathering these nations in the Middle East, by the Jehoshaphat, the judgment is for Israel's sake, man. Okay? So this is not to be all feel sad, feel sorry that 28,000 people died. Okay? This is judgment for Yahweh, Bash, and Yahweh Shah. We have to, as men, have to understand that, man. Okay?
Give the Most High a round of applause.
All praise to Yahweh, Bash, and Yahweh Shah.
Hey,
I'm going
to do better than that. Right. Hey, everybody celebrating LeBron. We celebrating the Lord number.
There you go.
It might end up being 38,000. Oh,
so
like
LeBron,
you know?
Lord, he's making our enemies our seniors just fall. No, within our own eyes.
Wait till it hits America. That's when it's going to change everything. That economy is now affected. 38,000 stripped from the economy?
Yeah.
Oh, that's gonna fuck some. That's gonna mess something up.
And the infrastructure.
He's a guess.
Oh, yeah. Okay. It's done. So what do they gotta do to rebuild? Okay, that's fucking up that economy.
Where are you?
Right there.
I'm over here.
Yeah.
That long. Yeah,
that long. I'm pretty sure a hurricane over there in Florida. Let's see. They calculated that it's going to cost like up to about millions just to get rid of the debris. Now, drive down to Santa Barbara, this beach so you can take the break. There's a bunch of wood and a bunch of shit on the beach.
Debris.
Yeah, debris from the storm. That's going to take a lot of money, a lot of time. Okay, and that's just that. Just imagine over there, that's an earthquake. You see a building.
Okay, you can't run from your past.
Esau. Wildlife looking ones.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah.
sometimes I get annoyed, but for the most part, patient driving, man. People lose patience over shit like that. How much more?
Yeah, they got that juice in them, that's what it is. You got a chick ramming her car into all the cars in the parking lot.
Yeah, I saw that.
Like, damn.
Crazy.
And everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby he have believed.
So it's all about what you did for Yahweh Hashem Yahushai.
Faith and works.
And yeah, and those tie it together, man, that faith and works, man. That's why right after you, man, faith is mentioned. Yeah. Alright?
Shall be preserved.
And it says too, the Lord says, whatever kind of work it be, whether it be good or bad.
Yeah.
But some people out here working, they ain't working, they working the wrong thing, man.
Yeah, they're working for that corrupt group.
Exactly.
Yeah.
To be seen in front of men.
Yeah, I'm the man.
I got 38,000. Passed the all-time score record.
Right.
Yeah, that's dope, though. That's,
yeah, that's cool. I'm not gonna, you know? But all that's going to be forgotten when this place gets burnt. So you think that's going to be mentioned in the
game? Hell no.
James, hey, man, you're hard.
That's why he sold his soul, though.
Shall be preserved from the said perils and shall see my salvation.
He got, I'm sorry, he got all that, but he only got one bitch.
Yeah, right.
If he does fuck other bitches, we gotta do it on the low. You know? We gonna be the top, man. We gonna have everything, man.
Yeah.
And our life and everything. Most importantly, we gonna be 100% righteous.
Yeah.
We gonna have to degrade ourselves for money and fame. That motherfucker last week, that dude last week said, you can't sell your soul.
You can't what?
He said, you can't sell your soul.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm saying that.
Brandon T. Jackson said it last week.
Oh,
yeah,
I
think he said, no such thing as selling your soul, something like that.
Yeah.
It's because he sold his soul. Right?
He said it's not yours to give away. Remember, he said you can't give it away. It's not yours to give away.
But that's why I told him it's a matter of compromising your integrity. It's a matter of degrading yourself, doing horrific things, man.
Yeah.
You got Bruno Mars, Jennifer Hudson. These people sacrificed their whole family. Right?
Yeah. You can tell the change from them selling their souls.
Yeah.
Because from a whole different person, the music started changing.
Demons consume them.
Right. Like Kanye West.
Demons come with that stuff, man.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I seen a clip. I was going to send it to you, but I know I didn't. But Travis Scott, right, as your boy.
Oh, that country?
Nah, he just was talking. But you can see that he's on drugs, bro. He's on fucking, bro. Yeah, he looks tall, like, he looks weird, bro. He doing a little crackhead moves and shit.
What's that, recently?
I don't know if it's recent, but I'll send it to y'all.
Yes.
Oh, fuck. Go ahead.
I'll send you that.
And shall see my salvation in my land.
Hey, no, read that again.
Verse 8. Shall be preserved from the said perils, and shall see my salvation in my land and within my borders, for I have sanctified them for me from the beginning.
Yeah. Hey, so it's all thinking, Yahweh Shem Yahushai, he chose you from the beginning, whether you were predestined.
Yeah.
Know that? Hey, that's what's going to save you, man, from these different dangers, man, from these plagues, man. Hey, it's all in the Lord, man, whether he chose you or not.
That's it, bro.
That's right. Come down, because
it's good. You want to be elected or not.
Huh? You can't make it some other than that.
No. You don't get involved. You know, you get called, so you're diligent. Hoping that we're part of the elected, you know?
The Lord said, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you.
He has some people that have problems with just hoping.
Oh yeah, they say they slandered or not slandered, but they call this faith-based Israelites. Man. You know,
well, all
like
the great men in scripture are faith-based.
Yeah, like there's something wrong.
Our
with
Lord
that.
Is faith-based.
Yeah.
Oh, you always say, oh, you little faith.
Oh, yeah. Little faith.
Your faith has made thee whole.
Exactly.
Yeah. We're prisoners of hope, like the Apostle Paul said.
If you have the faith in this mustard seed, move mountains.
Yeah.
Okay. That's the foundation of our whole nation.
Yeah.
Faith. Faith-based nation,
right? Yeah. Yahweh Shai said, be not afraid, only believe.
Yeah.
So they're going against the doctrine, the whole gospel.
Oh, for sure.
Going against the whole gospel. They're changing it to something different, man.
They're Antichrist.
Antichrist, all right?
What about that?
Look at that. And look at that sign.
Which one?
The car, look what the car's doing. And look at that sign.
No left turn. They don't know how to drive here. Yeah, you know.
Fuck, man, I don't mean
that's a woman, you know. Women don't listen to nobody, bro. Man, I can't wait for a little to humble these women.
Man. Yeah.
That's like one of my main, man.
Yeah. I look forward to it.
Man, I've been seeing that pride in their face, man. Their face is so, they got the most proud look ever.
Yeah.
With a ton of makeup on. Okay, that ain't even you.
And makeup was just there to hide their insecurities about themselves.
That's not what even
is.
Take that off your thing. Show me your real self.
Behind Esau Edom, a strong second for the worst creation ever is woman. And this time, you know, the worst creation is woman, man. I got to end the scripture.
Oh, yeah, sure.
It's 2 Ezra 16 and 37. Behold, the plagues draw nigh and are not slack, as when a woman with child in the ninth month bringeth forth her sons, within 2 or 3 hours of her birth, great pains compass her womb, which pains, when that child cometh forth, they slack not a moment.
Yeah, it's intensifying each and every one, more and more. Until back, it finally happens.
Yes. Each year go by, lower than the last year. But it gets worse. Things don't get any better.
Right.
They give you false promises, but it gets worse, man.
When it gets closer to the end, it gets closer to that birth. Okay? Time is not going backwards.
We're not going
backwards. You know what I'm saying? The baby's not going back up. You know what I'm saying?
Has it to where he switches to where the head gets to the vagina to come out.
Yeah.
The head has to come out first. It says, even so shall not the plagues be slack to come upon the earth, and the world shall mourn, and sorrows shall come upon it on every side. So the whole world about to feel what the Lord about to do, especially when that MOTB is implemented worldwide, globally.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, the Lord is about to do some things to change people's countenance, man. To take that pride off their face and shit. Okay. The Lord's about to wipe that out, man. Cause you people walk around here all proud and shit, thinking you did something of yourself, not knowing that the Lord's setting your ass up.
Failure.
Okay.
And we right here, the time of the Passover, man.
Yeah.
The Lord might have a jump right after the Passover.
Yeah.
I got 2 Ezra 8 and 50. Many great miseries shall be done to them that in the latter time shall join the world because they have walked in great pride.
And a misery breaks down to a state of great distress.
Agony.
You know? So that's what the Lord about to bring. A state of great distress upon you people, man.
And the scripture says they're going to howl over vexation of spirit. You know, there's going to be no out, no one to turn to at that point.
Mighty man shall cry there bitterly.
Yeah.
And that's also a sign, because the scripture says all these are the beginning of sorrow.
That's it.
Before Yahusha comes back, he's going to make sure these people feel these hurt pains, man.
Right, edge of sorrow.
Their whole life is going to be a thing.
Woe is me. Woe is me who lived me in those days.
Mm-hmm.
Beginning of death, beginning of plagues, famine. You know, but we can't do it.
God. And so with that, hey, Lord's will, you brothers were edified. Again, we'd like to give all praises, honor, and glory to
Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushai, Bashem, Rakakadash.
Hey, Brock the Yahweh.
Brock the Yahweh.
Brock the Yahweh.
Brock the Yahweh.
Hey, Brock the Yahweh.
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 Hey, Shalom, brother.